mine till they go out of business.
Well, you are saving yours until you go out of business. Cool.
Glad we got that live. What's up, everyone? Welcome to Plastic Fanatics, the late night podcast. I am your host, Victory Saber 77. Got a good show for you tonight. We are going to be looking at A Blast from the Past. I'm pretty sure you can tell what it's going to be, just to stay in, you know, with the theme of Halloween this month and all that. But let's get into some introductions, and while I'm introducing you, tell us if you got anything. If you didn't, make up something. Tell us what you want.
Yeah.
But let's get going here. Charles, how you doing?
What's up, man? Doing good, man. Doing good.
Good. You gonna stay awake this time?
Yeah.
All right. Awesome. And what did you get this week, or the last 2 weeks since there was no show last week?
Yeah. Last week I got my my real big BBTS haul came in last week. I was on vacation. I got SH Figure Arts Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Vegeta. Reissue the Hasbro MP10, and then the last two parts of my Planet X collection. I got Quirinus and Vulcan. So I got all five Dinobots. And then most recent purchase was two pop vinyls. So I'm a big AC fan. I picked up Jacob and Evie Fry. Well, pop vinyls.
Nice.
Anything else?
That's pretty much it.
No movies?
No.
All right.
Not yet.
Ooh, nice haul, man. That's awesome.
Thank you.
That is good.
Yeah.
All right. Next up is Tron Viper. How you doing?
What's up? How y'all doing tonight?
What's up, man?
Good. I got Fans Toys Spotter, which is their reflector.
Nice.
That's a really nice set. I'm mad that I waited as long as I did on it, but it's really cool. Let's see. I got a 1/12 Dio from Jarms. So shout out to Jarms for the Dio. And I got Transformers Devastation for PS4. It's like one of the free games this month that they're offering.
Okay.
So I got that. It's pretty fun. It's kind of short, though, but it is
yeah.
It's pretty cool. So that's it.
Cool. Nice. Like it. Like the Power Master Optimus Prime behind you.
Yeah.
Cool. Up next is Matt, the Iron Claw Ellis.
Hey, guys. Yeah. What did I get this week? I got X-Trom Transbot Ollie 2.0. I got Arcos. I got KFC Rover and Fader. I picked up an extra G2 MP Bumblebee for custom. I picked up Space Puppy today. Mr. Styling on sale. I think I might grab the G2 Superion set and use the limbs and make a combiner with that. Saw a guy in the cafe with it and I was like, I'd buy that. It looks pretty decent.
Cool.
Yeah. That's nice. I think pretty much all I got. Yeah.
Awesome. Up next, Mr. Green.
What's up, y'all? I got a new wallet with the Joker on it.
Ooh.
Sweet.
All right.
Spencer special.
Hell yeah. With a removable chain. So I could use it as a weapon.
Does it come with matching knife?
No, I'm going to have to pick one of those up in Chicago.
Shoot. All right, yeah. Anything else?
That's it, man. I've been no. Seriously, I got Lionel.
Cool. There you go.
That's a thing.
That's something. Or are you shaming it? You don't like it?
Oh, no. I like it. It's just I've had it for a bit. I really have not picked up anything because of TFCon.
Yeah.
You'll be getting something next week.
Oh, yeah.
He comes out. Also, Evil Lynn for the Filmation series.
Mm.
All right. Just to Russ, all by himself, having a party.
It's all quiet, Jim. Sun down there playing video games. He's all
I'm
quiet.
All by myself. I'd rather be on a nerdy show than just, you know.
I think too. I mean, I got I finally hit the jackpot with some of the new Star Wars figures that came out. I got the Kylo Ren without the mask. I got one of those, and I got I found the Death Viper. Not Death Viper, Death Trooper. The Death Trooper. He's pretty badass. I like him. He's really cool looking. And in Wu, I got something really special. I got a NECA figure stand.
Sweet. Woo! That's pretty sturdy.
Not bad. It's okay. I mean, it's just a pain because Kratos is kind of got a thick waist. So you have to open the thing up and like get it around his waist and kind of mess with it a little bit. But he's just a little dude, my badass, you know.
But it holds the weight pretty well if you want to have him like in a flight or jumping.
It does pretty well. He's kind of a heavy figure too. Which sucks. His legs are loose, kind of kills me. Then he had trouble making him stand, so I had to get the stand for him. He does keep it balanced, but he holds him pretty well. I mean, I put him in a couple poses. I've got him like, you know, doing some crazy Kratos jumping shit like he almost does in the game. So.
Cool.
Yeah, so it's pretty cool. It works out well.
Awesome. All right, next up. We're having some issues with us. You're going to have to get that hamster replaced. Get a faster wheel or something.
Nice.
Next up, Trends 5. How you doing, man?
Pretty good. And you, how's it going, sir?
I'm good. Any...
How was your weekend?
Well, it's going pretty good. Last weekend was okay. Son's birthday. That was about it.
Great.
But... did you get anything in the last couple of weeks?
Great, no. It's been kind of a lull here. Pretty much just the only thing that's in stores is like Wave 1. Wave 1 is now in full swing, so hopefully when Alamo City Comic Con comes up in about 2 weeks, I should be able to score something there.
Cool. Nice. Now, Trent, I'm curious. Do you collect more than just Transformers? Do you collect other stuff?
Mostly I do collect Transformers, but I do have a few other figures. I did get a Christmas party. I got like two of the original small size new Thundercat figures from like the 2000. What year series did that come out? Was it 2003? Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, around that era.
Cool.
And see, I did manage to pick up about two G.I. Joe figures just because I saw them in the store, and they were the cheap. It was a Duke and a Hunt for, was it the Hunt for Cobra, but Shadow Tracker.
Oh, nice.
Oh, that's a cool figure.
Yeah, the guy that looks like the Predator.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's cool. Awesome. All right. For me, I'm going to go through all the stuff I labeled or I said on ETR. X-Men Apocalypse Steelbook. I bought the DMC Devil May Cry game, Figure Arts Joker, Harley Quinn, the NECA Alien Frost and Vasquez figures along with some glow-in-the-dark eggs. I got the Fort Max, the Legends Takara versions, Striker Manus, Lino,
nice.
General Sunder and Night Stalker, Wave 1 of Rogue One, and also the Hover Pilot, that's the TRU exclusive, along with the RID Starscream, and I also got the NECA villain comic pack, that was a NYCC exclusive, along with some RID figures that I finally was able to find at Walmart, so Windblade, Scorponok, and Quillfire. Cool.
Nice.
Nice haul.
And I got some other stuff. but I can't get into that.
Jane, what do you think about those NECA alien figures? I saw them in Toys R Us today.
I think they're good.
I was thinking about pulling the trigger on a couple of them, and they looked good.
I saw a great set today, which was two face huggers in like tubes.
The creature pack.
That was really cool. Awesome, man.
It's a good time to, if you wanted to pick up some alien figures and such, now's the time, because we're getting finally some more Marines. We're getting, if you didn't get, I can't remember their names now, Hudson and Hicks at the very start, they're re-releasing them in an anniversary two-pack, which comes with both weapons and accessories from the two packs that they were originally released in, along with the single packs. So you can get that. I mean, it's a good time to start building up your army and all that. Mm. If you want to be on the show, the link is on my Facebook page, which is right underneath my name. Also, if you are part of the ROC, go to their Facebook page, and it's also in there in the group. And join us. Going to be talking some toy nonsense. We're going to do some kind of show announcement. So I'm going to be spoiling some stuff. Hopefully we won't, hear a lot of bitching about it, but we'll see. And then we will get into my blast from the past, which will be on Ghostbusters, the Filmations. If you haven't seen anything on the kind of the promos that I've been doing, that's what we're going to be looking at. So, all right. Screen sharing. Please work.
Hang out, cross your fingers.
Yeah, no, it's good.
Google Hangouts.
Google Hangouts is like, oh, that Victory Saber 77's out there. Let's fuck it up. He does not need to have that show. The only show on Saturday. All right, there we go.
Absolutely.
As you guys see, the logo, the thumbnail. You see it?
Yes.
Yep. The Matrix. All right, so this is episode 112. Got to go into my plugs. Enter the Realm. This Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Realm of Collectors YouTube channel. This is the show before TFCon. So next week is going to be a fun week. But we also have the ROC Hangout. Oh, wait. I think I got news about that. But I don't know if there's going to be an ROC Hangout next week. I think there might be. I know that there is going to be the ROC Hangout International on Tuesday.
Right.
That is the 18th at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Last show was really awesome. We got guys from the UK, we got Ish from Singapore, Northern Warriors, jumping in, all that. It's going to be a good show. Don't forget, though, there's going to be a figure banging this Wednesday. Don't know what it's going to be. But that is at 9:30-ish
Eastern Standard Time. 10 o'clock.
Pretty much. It's whenever, I'm sure Ace will be there early enough. But we'll see. It'll be good. It's always good. It's
a good show. It's a great show.
You get to see some really good stuff. A little more in-depth than a review. A lot more banter, which is really nice. Next up, the ROC pack. The Rock Pack. This is our little kind of fundraiser. Go pre-order it right now if you're going to be at TFCon, so you can pick it up while I'm messing up all over the place. Sorry. Get the Rock Pack at Realm of Collectors, www.realmofcollectors.com. It's $30. You don't just get a t-shirt, which is fantastic. I should know. I just got it in the mail today. I love it. But you get a whole bunch of other stuff. Also, if you pre-order, you will be entered twice into the $100 Agabus giveaway, which is spectacular. I mean, $100 for free? I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Sizes are selling out fast. There's no more smalls, and I believe the 5X large are gone, and I'm not sure about extra large.
Medium's gone as well.
Medium's gone, extra too. Large is gone. All right, so
time to slim down or gain weight, depending on what size you need. But definitely pick it up. $30. They're also going to have it at the show, but if you buy it at the show, you only get one entry. So we'll let you guys know when the drawing is going to be for that $100 giveaway, Agabus giveaway. Most likely it's going to be Saturday. But and we'll let you guys know about the pickup. And if you're not going to TFCon like me, hit them up. There is a post in the ROC Facebook group. Just, you know, get in there, say, hey, I'm not going to be there, but I want to pre-order this. Can someone send it to me? And we will hook you up. Yeah, so there's no reason not to get this.
Absolutely.
Yeah, Russ is hooking me up. Russ and Anna. Thank y'all.
Well, you know, there you go. Man, it's not a problem, man. I've got you. I've got a couple other people I'm grabbing for. I'm like, dude, that's it. Come on, bring it on. I got room.
It's called muling.
Yeah.
It's all about muling.
That's it.
But next up, if you don't know about Crashbox Customs, we'll get on board because Mr. Pinkerton is killing it with his dios. I just saw a little sneak peek of one that he's working on, and damn, that is good. He is setting the bar very, very high. And contact him through Facebook. He also has an IG page on our Crashbox Customs. Check out his work. Skullface, you know, Bobby Skullface did a review of it also. So definitely, he will have some at TFCon for sale and such, but definitely hook him up. And, you know, it's not just about the designs that you see here. He will pretty much do whatever you like. I mean, he's done Thundercats, and I know he's probably going to be dabbling into other stuff too. So, and no fee is too high. But yeah, definitely. And then next up is the Cool Table Network, where like-minded podcasts, you can find us on the Cool Table Podcast Network Facebook page. We have Shattercast Uncut there, Enter the Realm, Beers, and Bolters 40K. We also have Nerd Rage Radio, Toy Detox, 8 Weeks. Check us out. Like the Facebook page. Go check out the YouTube. Like, subscribe, or listen on iTunes. Give us a 5-star rating. And there we have it. All right. And I got a plug, Mr. Deluxe. You know, I had him on here, and I dropped him. I got to put him back on here. I love Hale Hasbro reviews. I want that guy to succeed. I want him to have, you know, a ton of subscribers. So if you haven't subscribed to Mr. Deluxe Baldwin, go over to his YouTube page and subscribe. Like his stuff. I mean, you get floor time. I mean,
you have
on.
Floor time.
It's all about floor time.
Absolutely.
And the dude knows what he's talking about, so go check him out. All right, this was just funny to me. Taking a look at a little screenshot that I found on eBay. It's the TMNT Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles NECA Villains NYCC pack. This is a pre-order. You can buy it now for $1,999.99.
How much is shipping? Free. Oh, it's free.
It's free shipping, though, so that's But hey.
I'm gonna get them to mark that it's only $100 so I don't get hit with customs.
I mean, $500 a figure? I mean, shit, that's cheap. I mean, these things are like, go for it.
Remember, Jane, you're not a true collector if you don't overpay.
I know. Yeah, totally. So
that's a first release, though. I mean,
yeah, you're out there.
Yeah, and this is the unsigned version. Just think, if you got it signed.
Oh,
just think.
There's all that. There's all that empty room to get signatures on it.
Oh yeah. So, great seller.
Mm.
All right, next up, did you guys watch the latest Rogue One trailer?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Like
no.
It? No. Damn.
No.
No. Well, this is the part of the show that we're going to be going into a little bit of spoilers.
What?
So did you guys that did see it, like it, like kind of the reveals, like how it's heading?
I don't know. I'm kind of swearing it off. I'm not watching any more of them because I don't want to know anymore.
Okay.
You may want to leave the room, Russ.
God, that's right.
Oh, we won't talk too much about it, but I was just kind of curious. No, I kind of liked it. I liked how we know more about Jen's father.
which I thought was going to be someone else, but that's cool. He shares his same first name, but
I haven't even seen Force Awakened yet.
Oh my God!
What?
Oh, the eruption!
I haven't even seen the trailer for Force Awakened.
Oh, damn!
You gotta be kidding me!
I'm a little behind.
Well, there's something to do on the ride to TFCon.
Yeah, maybe it'll be on the plane.
Yeah. There you go.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness. Somebody get this guy a copy of Force Awakens.
Yeah. Bring a tablet. Download that shit to a tablet and watch it on the way there. Oh, my gosh.
Someone please get mad. All right, well, let's move on to everyone's favorite topic. DC TV shows.
Television.
Yes, I like Supergirl. I had a good time.
Supergirl, Flash, Arrow, and DC Legends of Tomorrow.
And the Flash.
We got Supergirl with Superman. Did you? And has anyone seen this or not seen this?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Okay, good.
Not the new season, no.
Some bitch. All alone on this island.
I have not watched any of these ones. I'm working on Gotham right now.
Yeah, Gotham's good.
I like Gotham a lot.
I like Gotham too, but I like this is at least more kind of fun to play with.
Oh, for sure.
In the show. But Supergirl, we got to see Superman for the first time, so that whole embargoed shit is out the window. So that's nice. And we got to see a new villain, which is actually a good villain. Which is Metallo.
Metallo. Metallo's awesome, man.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that they finally introduced him because he was actually introduced in the same comic book as Supergirl, Action Comics 252.
Ooh.
Wow. Nice.
The modern version though was released in the 87 Superman number one. I think that was the year, but I think it looks pretty good. I'm wondering if we will get his kind of Terminator look. His robotic look.
He like an alien android? What's his story? For those who don't know, AKA.
He is a human who was outfitted with kryptonite into a cybernetic body.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, he's almost the perfect killing machine for Kryptonians,
Yeah.
Amazing, so.
I'll always remember if you have seen or read the Superman Batman Public Enemies, where he shoots Superman with a bullet. I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
And they're having the little fight scene in the cemetery. Pretty badass. All right. Yeah. Next up, moving into Flash. So we have the Rival, which is kind of like, I guess you could say, the reverse Flash for Jay Garrick.
Another reverse Flash. Okay.
We're supposed to get another guy, Salvatore or something like that. But, yeah. Years.
Oh, sorry. I thought it was Savitar.
I've heard it's supposed to be the Rival, but I've heard it's supposed to be that other guy too. But the guy's name, I forgot. What's his name? Clarion or I forgot. Isn't he the Rival's? Edward Claris? I believe that's the Rival's name. So. But again, we're taking on another speedster. We get to see another speedster.
And it's more speedster. How many are they up to on the show now?
For good and bad?
Yeah.
Oh, we just got Jesse Quicks coming next week. Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd say at least 7.
I mean, Flash is all about the speedsters, I guess.
It is. Everyone's a speedster now. That's the thing.
Yeah.
I like it.
I guess, that's one thing I always find a lot of superhero shows and movies do where they end up sort of fighting themselves. And I guess The Flash just takes that all to new levels because it's like themselves fighting themselves with themselves. And, it's pretty intense.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And the thing that we're getting now with Flash is the fact that he is screwing up the timeline. So he's fucking up his relationship with Iris. Every single thing. I need my mom back. No, kill my mom. Okay, I'm back. Oh, Iris is gone. Oh, I got to fix this. No, Iris still loves me. Okay, all this. It's kind of getting a little too much drama with that. But
too much timeline drama.
Yeah, too much. Next up, we're getting introduced to Dr. Alchemy or Mr. Element. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty cool.
Introduced. His mask looks pretty cool.
Yeah, his costume looks pretty badass.
It kind of looks like the X2 power armor from Fallout, to be honest, but it's pretty cool.
So it's not original. Well, they tried. But moving on into this, everyone's favorite, Wild Dog. We're into Arrow now.
Okay.
So Oliver needs a new team since all his other followers left him. So no more Speedy, no more Diggle. I think Roy needs to come back. I want more Arsenal. But he's got Wild Dog.
So and who can use a Wild Dog?
I mean, come on. I need a Wild Dog.
So he's just like he's Casey Jones with a gun.
That's what I was about to say.
Casey pretty Jones. Much, yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Instead all you gotta say is get back on the line if you watch the episode. And I believe they're giving us a new canary too. I think. And then Ragman here. Which
is this an arrow?
This is an arrow, yes.
No, I always read about Ragman. I thought he was pretty cool sounding character. I mean, in here he looks a lot like Arkham Knight Scarecrow, minus the gas mask.
True.
But, yeah.
But yes, he got in here. He was, you know, if you haven't seen it, sorry, but they thought he was the bad guy, the villain, but he actually turned out to be kind of the good guy. And he's joining Team Arrow, along with we're getting Mr. Terrific. So that's pretty.
And what's his power again? Something to do with like the different elements of his costume sewn into it or something?
Yeah. Hence rags.
Rags.
It all ties into what Damian Dark did in the previous season and all that. That's how they're tying in this character. Next up, also an arrow. We're getting Prometheus. He finally said his name on Prometheus to what's his face? But this. They've stated that it's not the Prometheus we know from the comics, supposedly. And these are the different appearances of Prometheus. He was in Blue Beetle, Prometheus, One Shot, and then also Batman Gotham Knight. He's a cool looking character, but again, like we saw in Flash, taking on a reverse Flash or Speedster, it looks like we get...
Reverse Arrow?
Yeah, we get another Arrow. And their costumes are just like, wow, really? Can we not get a Deathstroke with some shininess and all that? But all right.
Yeah.
Next up for DC Legends of Tomorrow, the JSA was hinted at the last episode of the previous season. Well, we got to see them in the season premiere of season two. We get Stargirl, Dr. Midnight, Commander Steel, Obsidian, Vixen, and Hourman. Or actually, Hourman's right there, sorry. And then Commander Steel. So, yeah, very interesting. They need to bring back Captain Cold.
Right. He was the best character in season one, man.
He was.
Oh, man.
Heatwave, him and Heatwave were really good.
They were. Heatwave was good, too. I agree.
And so it's I'm curious to see where they're going with this, but we'll find out. We have Amber Heard is going to be Mira, Aquaman's woman, queen of Atlantis in the new Justice League.
Pretty good costume.
Yeah, that is actually pretty cool.
Pretty great.
Yeah,
kind of enchantress looking.
Yeah.
A little bit. Yeah. I mean, there's Atlantean elements in there.
Yeah. It looks good.
Yeah.
So that's my movie stuff. Moving into Transformer news now.
What is this?
This is the only human figures released by Funpub. Unfortunately, we're not going to get the entire set because they are now gone. But we're getting Rodimus. You can go with your old man Snake.
So, sorry, who is this? With a fish?
This is Rodimus.
Oh, Rodimus.
If you remember the season 3 Only Human episode.
Right.
Yeah, that's their take on him. So, it's funny. He comes with a fish.
And he still gets a fish, which is obviously the most important thing.
Yeah.
Is that a northern pike, or is it some sort of salmon?
Steelhead.
Some kind of small sturgeon.
Yeah, it could be a sturgeon.
I've always wondered if that episode somehow came out of the old season 1 episode, Out of Our X. Remember what Bumpy says at the end?
Keep going.
What if a Transformer's mind could be put in the body of a human?
Oh, yeah. Damn. Probably.
Bumblebee was the mastermind behind it all. Shit.
Yeah.
Leave it up to Bumblebee.
He's been a spy this entire time.
Leave it up to Bumblebee to come up with a shit idea like that.
But next up, we're getting an RC.
Yep, that's probably what she'd look like.
So, I mean, it's pretty close to what we saw on screen. But again, we're not getting... I don't know if she can hold that. I guess this is for a Transformer because it's a 5 mil.
It's got the 5 mil peg, yeah.
But we're not getting a cup or a... No, we didn't get a cup. Sorry. Excuse me. Springer or Ultra Magnus. I really wanted to see an old man Ultra Magnus.
Yeah. You just need a human who just doesn't have time for that right now.
But there we go with that.
There's that.
Another little fun pub exclusive is their Ninja Force and Transformer set.
I'd take that Rat-Bat.
The Rat-Bat's cool, yeah.
And I guess that G2 Megs is pretty cool.
Yeah, I'd take all those. I do like the Cobra.
Cobra Commander looks pretty cool. Is that Ravage, I guess, in Cobra G.I. Joe mode, I guess?
Sure. It's supposed to be, kind of their boxes depicting the comic book here. G.I. Joe starring Snake Eyes. I love that. It's like G.I. Joe can't carry itself on its own. We need to put Snake Eyes in there. It's like the X-Men starring Wolverine.
They've transcended the,
But you can read the kind of the inner workings.
Do you know what the set's going for?
No, I don't actually. It's on their website for pre-order. Right now. Oh, it's Black Cat. Autobot Black Cat.
What's her name? Dr. Shigglesworth, is that her name?
Oh, it's an Autobot. Wonderful.
Yeah. Well, yeah. It's not too bad. I mean, yeah, I would love to have the G2 Rat-Bat. That looks good.
Yeah.
But I don't really need the rest of these.
I think I need to find a G.I. Joe fan who wants the other half of that. They can keep the box. I'll take it. The two bots in the bottom.
All right, next up, we saw this at, I think, the Taipei, I forgot what it's called, show. This is a pretty cool thing. The Toys Alliance Mega Action Series. This is MS-01 Optimus Prime. 18 inches worth of tallness. Going for a price that Dust only loves. $179.99.
Is it $179.99? That's wonderful.
Yes.
Yeah, wow.
Here he is doing a superhero landing.
Wait, that thing is only one. It was for real? Only $179.99?
Only.
I mean, yeah, right. He doesn't transform, obviously.
No. Yeah. But it looks really impressive. If you just want a really sweet ass looking Optimus Prime robot mode,
he's like an action master.
Yeah.
Beefy bot.
He's beefy.
Yeah.
Removal matrix, light up feature.
Yeah, he is pretty beefy.
You haven't seen what's coming up next year. Release in the in the fourth quarter of this year.
Skadoosh.
And I love the fact that it's official. That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Hasbro, Takara, and all that.
It's a nice head sculpt.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
It's a little more streamlined than the MP head.
Yeah.
It looks like it's got a lot of detail in it, man. Like,
Look at him next to MP10, eh? Oh.
Yeah.
That's a centerpiece right there.
Yeah, it's yeah. Nice.
I think the price point's pretty good.
Actually,
I think it's justifiable. Yeah, 18 inches. Sure.
That's a big figure, man.
Shit, yeah. I'm buying PlayArt's Kai for $200 that are not even
look at the size
of that.
He's got some, he's got some weathering, like the screw rivets are painted silver. I mean, he's got some like extra detail, you know? He's
the symbol on the shoulder, it kind of like sets up, you know.
But that Megatron, though. No.
But we're getting a Megatron, so he doesn't have to be alone.
Oh.
So that's nice. Kind of cool.
Yeah.
He looks beefy, too. But...
Yeah.
All right, speaking of beefy, we have Toy Alliance's Tepe-K Gokin TP-01 Fall of Cybertron Optimus Prime.
So how many people do we have in the Fall of Cybertron game right now? Planet X?
Yeah.
And these guys, right? That's it?
Yep.
Unless you're counting like the Iron Factory or the little, you know, the little Legends class.
Oh, but this must be, is this not sponsored officially? It must be.
This is official, yeah. This is official.
Yeah, okay.
So it doesn't transform.
Oh, it does not look like it transforms. I don't know.
I don't think so, but damn, he's big.
Yeah.
Nice.
No pre-order, no price point yet on this guy. So your guess is as good as mine. Let's just go with $179.99. $179.46.
Oh, and that's all the die cast on it.
Yep.
Oh, it's got LED eyes. Cool.
Nice.
Yeah, it's not bad.
I like how he's like this. His dude has body. His head just looks small to me.
Yeah.
He's shaming now. Come on.
I'm not into body shaming, but.
He's got like the Incredible Hulk body.
He's
like
got, a banner. Got a little head.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
All right, next up. We have Shattered Glass MP10.
Yeah, I like it. The trailer's nice too.
I am debating whether to get this or not. I'm really
no debate. Just
I pre-ordered it. It's already pre-ordered for me.
Now this is a Hasbro Asia or Hasbro, so we're not getting that typical Takara box. Looks like we're looking at the more platinum looking style box. The artwork looks nice though. It's got the window flap.
You know, I wish the Platinum line would do this instead of giving us, like, clear and orange repaints of MP figures, you know?
Yeah.
Let's just make
it... like the Blitzwing Astro Train.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you mean. This is nice. I just don't know how far they're going to, like, go...
down the rabbit hole.
Yeah, yeah. Like, they have a Grimlock. Yeah. They could do a Shattered Glass Grimlock, but...
they could do Sideswipe. He looks great in Shattered Glass.
Oh, yeah. So,
Shattered Glass ideas itself is really cool. You know, just
they could do Soundwave as well, the white Soundwave. And...
oh yes, damn, I would love that.
Yeah, I'd buy that.
Here is Thrust, another $179.99.
Yep, I've got this guy. I'm one of the jerks who paid for it. I'm one of the guys.
The hope and his shoulders are going to be messed up.
Yeah, exactly.
I just want I want full disappointment. I'm paying that price for it.
I think he looks good.
Yeah, I do too. I think he looks good. You look at the animation.
I mean, he's no Toy World.
He's no Toy World. He's no iGear, but you know, I'll settle for the official. What the hell?
Settle official.
Speaking of more official stuff, we got the first of the Beast Wars Masterpiece figures, Convoy, Beast Convoy, Optimus Primal. I love the box. I wonder if the box is going to be really small.
The box is pretty cheesy 90s box art. I like it.
Yeah, I do too. I like the eye, the back. Yeah. You know, it's perfect.
Yeah,
perfect for sure.
And you get a nice assortment of accessories, the facial expressions for his robot mode, even facial expressions for his ape mode.
Yeah, that King Kong face is pretty great.
And you get his swords. Just get pissed off and like, hey, you brought me a flower. That's cool.
That's like, that's his like, I'm proud of you, Rhinox face. And that's his like, ah.
The other one's like, oh, oh man, what did you put in that energon?
Or is shut up, rat trap face.
Yeah.
I do wish that this would have had an accessory piece from, I forgot what the episode it was, but the when Scorponok shot him with that stinger bee thing that made him all pissed off and had like...
Yeah, yeah.
He had all like the, you know, he went on a just a warpath. Little bit of, you know, yeah, damage to his helmet, to his body, all that type of stuff, having that thing that they're, oh man, that was a good episode. But he has all his typical weapons, shoulder cannons, his gauntlet cannons, wrist cannons. You can store his weapons on him.
Yeah, it's pretty tight cool all around.
Yeah. And there he is to the original animation. Pretty spot on.
Nailed it.
Yeah.
No complaints here.
Some people were talking about how the paint is on the on it. Some people were complaining about it, and I guess the way, to me it looks good, but I guess some people are saying it's, I guess the way it's done, it doesn't look, it looks strange.
Russ,
I mean,
remember, we're Transformer collecting fans like the bit.
That's true.
Nothing can ever be perfect.
Right. Find something wrong with it. That's true.
Yeah. We have to.
He looks really cool though. I have to admit.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Oh yeah.
Easy pass for me, but
next up is Spark Toys Steel Lock. This is our War Within Grimlock, another beefy one.
Wow!
Wow! How big
is he? Well, there he is next to a water ball.
Yeah, I mean,
I mean, he's a lot bigger than their Alpha Pack or whatever their Optimus was or is.
Yeah,
I don't have him. Ah, I forgot that big. Oh well, what? He's a big guy.
Spoiler.
Next up is Perfect Fusion's Cesium, their masterpiece Slag. This is their PF-01, the first of the release of Dinobots, or only, we don't know. This is going to be released fourth quarter this year, $139.99.
I'm in for him.
Competing with Gigapower's Grasser.
I mean, competing with all the other Dinobots that already came out, right?
True, if you can get them for that low of a price point.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, like, I don't have Scoria, so, I mean, this one looks a little bit more tuned, so I'm in for these guys. Well, hopefully they do more than just this one, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He looks all right. He looks good.
No die cast, though, I believe.
Oh, yeah, right. That.
But I'm fine with that. I mean,
yeah.
At least it's reflected in the price. It would really suck if this came out at $199 and like no diecast. Like, okay, come on.
Yeah.
Come on, guys.
But there he is with the other fans' toys, Dinobots.
I guess He gets a pass.
I'm sure this one's tail won't break off. But that's just me. There they are in dinosaur mode, ready to kick some ass.
Fuck some shit up.
They are next Prime. I mean, he's a beefy guy.
Yeah.
Wow.
So.
Nice. I see. I think those guys are all like scaled pretty well to Prime. That's like how I imagine the Dinobots being, you know, just slightly bigger than Prime. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it looks good. Again, if you missed out on Scoria, like what we said, definitely this is one to go after. I know that Big Bad Toy Store, they're getting more Scoria in. But again, yeah. $199, or do you want to just pick up this guy for $139? You never know.
Yeah.
Or buy them both. Hey, what the hell? And get Grasser while you're at it, too.
Buy them all.
Buy them. And then switch over to, you know, Toy World's version, and then you need to get the fan, you know, Fans Project's version, and then you need Planet X, and then you need G Creations.
That's 0.1% to get all that.
Damn right. I'm a little obsessed with this guy, so I have to always feature him on the show. We're looking at KFC Simba.
Come on, Dave, to the game.
Masterpiece Victory Leo waiting to grace my home soon. $159.99 released this month. The clock is ticking. I swear, if you guys are at TFCon and you show me a picture of him there, I will PayPal someone the money to get him for me. If this hasn't dropped yet.
I'll tell you what, Jamie. I don't know much about the character myself, but I'll tell you what, he just looks nice as a, you know, just as a figure. He looks really cool.
All I gotta say is he completes me.
He completes
like my Star Saber. He looks complete.
Now this fucking guy is what I've been waiting for.
So this is Toy Base's Master Series MS-01 Arch Enemy. Their Masterpiece Black Convoy from Car Robots or RID. They say that this is Scourge from RID, but we know this is from Car Robots because of the upside down G2 Autobot symbols. But hey, they tried. But it looks really good. He's more in tune to the RID version, which would have been better if they would have done that, but oh well.
Yeah, and
with this, the teal color.
This is their first entry, right? So yeah. Into the game, I think it's a good choice. It's a pretty easy transformation to mimic.
Oh yeah,
and it, you know, people want this figure. I know.
Now, do you want electronics, like a light up sword feature, like we had with the original Optimus?
Oh, I mean, Make Toys did it with the battle tankers. I don't care for the light up crap, to be honest.
With that panel on the top of the cab. Right where you had your thing on the new one. Could that be for electronics?
Good.
That looks like a
battery port or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. But they nailed it. I mean, look at that. They added some cool kick plates on the back of the arms and stuff. He looks really good.
Yeah, he does. And they're also doing a more G1 style Overlord.
Yes. Yeah, I saw that.
Which looks really good too.
Which I'm super jazzed about.
But yeah, this looks awesome. They're next in the line. Oh, there he is in vehicle mode.
Oh, nice. They nailed that long cab. It looks really good.
Yeah.
But they are doing the Optimus Prime version. So MS-02 Gunfighter 2.
That's pretty cool. You know, I'm not big on that Prime mold, but I would almost consider buying that. It's pretty cool looking.
Yeah. I'll probably end up buying these because I have every iteration of this mold. I have this, the reissue, the Magnus, both of the ones from RID and Car Robots, even the Year of the Goat.
The Year of the Goat.
Yeah. I said, screw it. Why not? What the hell?
Oh, man. Yeah.
But, yeah, it looks good.
Yeah, he's cool.
I don't know why they have, like, you can pose him the same way as the original. I'm hoping you can pose them better than the original.
Yeah,
that's true.
But yeah, it does look good.
These are his iconic poses, though.
He has an ankle rocker. Mm-hmm. That's cool. Yeah. Like it.
He bends right all the way places.
Rubber tires.
Figure not to scale, it says. Slightly bigger.
Well, this is supposed to be MP scale, right?
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they nailed the gradient paint job.
Yep.
That's pretty cool. Although he has a red windshield instead of a clear. I wouldn't care, but I just for those who do.
Yeah. All right. Next up is X Transbots MX3 Elgos, their Masterpiece Cyclonus. Dropping this month, going for $179.99.
Oh, really? Damn.
Is it?
That's pricey.
That's from BBTS. Now, again, prices can vary depending on where you shop, who you shop with. I'm just giving you what you would find at an e-tailer. So, shout out to Ace, who gets the deals. But I just go where it's readily available.
Fact.
But I like him. I do like the sword.
Yep.
Everything about it.
He looks good.
I love the head, man. This head is beautiful. It's got a big long one. I great.
Both modes look good.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome.
I mean, it's slavish to the G1, but there was nothing really wrong with the G1 except for the head sculpt.
Yeah, true.
And all that, so.
They need that. Oh, all the different ways. Is that a miniature Galvatron? To
fit yep. Yes, it is.
He's the one that put him in the cockpit.
Dude, yeah. that right there might have sold me on it. All the way.
The flight stand's a nice touch, too.
Yep.
The sword.
Yeah.
Sword solid.
And the Target Master.
Yeah.
What's the alternate face? Does anything show it? Or
no, oh. It's I believe it just darkens his goatee.
Okay.
But I don't have a...
Gives him a soul patch.
A little soul patch there. Evil look.
Midlife crisis, Cyclonus.
Now, was it true? Is Cyclonus made from Bombshell from the movie?
I say Skywarp.
Oh, Skywarp? Okay.
That's what I say. The debate goes back and forth.
Because I would love to see a face sculpt of like one of those characters that you could put on here. You know, just
that would be really cool.
But, all right, up next for Russ. Transformers that he is so into. And $99 a piece. He wants these so bad. He's going to buy 2, 3, maybe even 4.
That drag strip fucking fell flat.
I agree. That's my first disappointment as far, you know, I think. I don't know how done it is. That looks pretty done though to me. But.
We're looking at M05 Revolt drag strip. What's wrong? 02 Carnage Breakdown.
The drag strip to my robot mode?
Look at that. Power Train, their Motor Master.
He looks fucking menacing. Look at him.
Yeah. So, like, these are deluxe scale?
No,
these are Master.
They're MP car size, man.
But, yep. But it's
okay. They're upscale.
And this guy is MP10 size. Motor Master's is.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
For some
reason, they look really small on the pictures.
Well, I know. It's because it's terrible photography. I mean,
it's terrible to blame it on the photography.
They didn't even knock the crinkles out of their backdrop. Look at that amateur.
I know.
Come on.
Could have at least ironed it.
Steamed it. That.
Not there, I mean.
And at least this
Yeah,
the vehicle mode of Powertrain Motor Master is actually looking better than what we saw at the previous show.
The guy who set that up got over it pretty quick. I think he was like, "Fuck this thing."
Honestly, I like to beat that guy's ass the last time he pissed me off. It looks so bad.
But yeah, this is the same size as MP10. I mean,
Like the trailer seems a little shorter, doesn't it?
I think it probably it might be a little short.
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm not knocking it. I'm just
I think you're right. I think it is lengthwise.
But yeah, it's thick. It's thick. So
yeah.
So yeah. Ross, are you still in on these?
Yeah, I am, man. Can't give up. This guy's gonna be.
He's committed.
And is Anna supporting you with these? Or is this on the down low? Like,
No. This is what Anna says. She says, she says, go and get them. But if I hear you open your mouth one time about this appointment, I'm going to beat your ass. That's what she says.
Lay down the law.
You know, if you have to sing something at karaoke at TFCon, it should be Stand By Your Man.
Does she ever? You got a little bit of a nice little sign right by your door. We'll love the Transformer. Or I'll beat your ass.
Yeah.
Words to live by.
You better love it.
That's cool though.
He's I don't know. I'm getting to love it because I got a feeling when you go to combine this guy, it's gonna be like crazy parts for me.
Yeah.
Like
shit
all over the place.
Yeah. And, I mean,
can you videotape that, Russ, when you're doing it? I would love
Fig-a-bang. I think Russ should get his own Fig-a-bang episode for that one.
Oh my god. But you got to watch me and watch the frustration on it. I'm throwing shit around.
No, I fucking like it. It's great.
To get a tractor trailer and have it be the same size as an MP10 and a combiner, if it parts for them, all the more better.
I agree with you. I agree. As long as the combiner mode is whatever they have to do to make it stable.
When you look at...
they got this little sticky tack. I think that might help.
Hey, I'm like Russ. I'm all in for this as soon as it goes on clearance.
Don't you kill him.
It hits the cafe.
Just wait for the fan toys render, and then you'll get it on the cafe for cheap.
I really do like the aesthetics of the combiner. I could care less about the individual modes because when I buy something like this, I'm never going to
play
individual modes.
I'm still surprised that there hasn't been another third-party company that wants Attack of the Stunningons. Give us something proper.
It's weird. It's really weird because Manasaur is like one of those iconic Decepticon miners, you know, especially from G1.
They survived the war. I mean, they survived,
The war.
they survived to make it the season 3. They were
survivors.
Survivors.
All right, next up, we're looking at the TFCon Chicago exclusive. This is Ocular Max's PS01S Sphinx Stealth Alternate Edition. This is much like the one that was released at Toronto, but all the clear parts are on the opposite.
Except the gun is still clear and the head
except for the gun.
Yeah, which is the same. So this is the Chicago flip.
Yes. And this will be supposedly 500 limited. Maybe less, depending on the boat.
You just got to take into account that 250 will be sold to another vendor before any of us get in the room.
Pretty much. And it goes for around $120.
That's not bad.
I think you have to get an A3.
For those who missed
it. A3U, I think, is going to be selling them.
Personally, so what I want to see is if whoever bought the Toronto one and picks this one up, please try and make one clear and one fully colored version.
Well, it won't match because the clear from Toronto has orange accents and this has blue.
Good eye.
I didn't catch that.
Works for me though.
Now I got the early access crap to the deal rooms. Do I get early access to this?
If their Ages 3 and up is willing to sell it, but it being an exclusive,
they're gonna wait until a certain time to sell it, probably.
You might be able to. Maybe, maybe not.
Last year when we were in Charlotte, he went in and after everyone was in there, that's when they announced that they were starting to sell the exclusives. So they might do it differently. I don't know.
I'm sure if you are BBTS or someone big, you work something underneath. But there are the two different versions. You have the Toronto on the left and Chicago on the right. Like what Nick was saying, you got the orange and then you got the blue, but still
the Toronto kind of looks cooler to me, honestly,
especially with the translucent head.
I think it was a win in the end, but
yeah,
good for the people who missed it.
Goddamn Canadians get everything better than we do.
Except for one thing, which is prices on every fucking thing we buy, so you enjoy that.
It's cool that they did something different with it, though, that they reverted it. You know, they could have just done the same thing. Like that they made it its own. It kind of makes us feel like we're getting our own exclusive.
It makes it actually an exclusive, you know.
Yeah, as soon as we saw it, we said that we're going to get one that's reversed at TFCon.
That's what a lot of people said, so shout out to them.
Yeah, I was hoping. But I didn't
know. And hopefully those people went out and bought a lottery ticket.
Yeah, really.
Now this guy...
This guy right here, we're looking at the Ocular Max PS10 Road Crane, their MP hauler.
Yeah.
I love the kick chat this afternoon about the banter going back and forth of who the hell this person is.
For sure, right?
TFCon Chicago exclusive. This is going to be limited to 500 pieces again.
Got to get it.
It looks good.
Yeah.
I mean, the Diclone shelf is growing. I love.
You know what I'd love for him is like a distinctly Decepticon looking head, alternate head.
Oh, to be modeled after the 7th Constructicon.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I was going to ask, cuz like the 7th Decepticon, like the 7th and 8th fucking Constructicons, like one of them was supposed to be in a G1 episode, but it was just colored just like Grapple.
Yeah. That was a mistake by Hasbro. I think they had the toy ready, but they ended up shipping an extra Mirage in the case with each one. There's 12 bots, and they sent 2 Mirages with every case, and then, you know, this fellow never got released, and eventually they colored him yellow, put him in the cartoon as Grapple.
Yeah. And, yeah, I mean, we saw in the first episode he was called, and this was a debate that everyone was talking about.
Road Hauler?
Was Hauler. Cliffjumper referred to him as Hauler, but he was orange or yellowish, you know, and so everyone thought it's Grapple. The story behind him from the eHobby exclusive was the fact that he was a Constructicon, but he turned and became an Autobot.
Not on my shelf.
And all that type of stuff. So.
Could you imagine that, though, an 8-piece combiner? That would be so fucking fun.
That would be so sturdy.
It would fall apart everywhere, but I got an 8-piece combiner.
Man, why do I got to be the ass?
Yeah. Why do I have to be the kickstand?
Damn it.
It was a missed opportunity, man. They could have had some really good storyline on that.
You know,
you're the crutch. Yeah.
I've got Make Toys Hellfire and Grapple, so this is a great excuse to grab the MMC mold.
Yeah.
To compare them.
Now, we are getting an official Grapple, so they're probably maybe down the road.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But that'll be a Takara Mall exclusive, no doubt.
Yeah. Much like their Delta Convoy and
179
and all that type of stuff. Yeah, probably will be. $179.99. But you get so many different face sculpts.
Yeah, all those faces. Yeah, no, this looks awesome.
Vehicle mode looks good.
It would have been cool to have the Constructicons like and him have kind of like this, you know, nasty back and forth with each other. It would have been great.
Seeing this makes me want to get Gravity Builder even more, just to have them together, you know?
Yeah, no, that's pretty cool, actually. Good idea.
Next up is something I'm just throwing out here. It's the Wei Jiang M02 Robot Force Age of Extinction Hound.
With his bicycle helmet. Looks really good.
Yeah, I like this. She loves this character. She loves
scaled.
That fucking movie drove me insane. I don't know.
I did like this character though.
John Goodman was a great pick for the voice, and you know he was decently motivated in the movie, unlike some of the other characters.
What was it, fat ballerina coming through?
Great. But you know he's like a mash in the movie, like every Bayverse thing. He's a mashup of like Cup and. And Hound and every fucking and Bulkhead and like you know
that's
what you're Iron High Bulkhead pretty much
just smash them together and fucking sell some toys.
Staying with the movie toys, we have an anniversary. Can you believe a movie anniversary?
We are getting
reissues with better paintups and such.
That's Michael Bay shitting on the G1 anniversary, saying like, "Well, our anniversary is here too."
Yeah, pretty much. So we got Optimus Prime.
Yup.
And then we got Bumblebee.
Wow.
Yeah. Ooh. And we got the deluxe version of Ironhide. Yeah,
that was the best one, obviously.
And we got Ratchet.
Rat shit.
Yeah, rat shit is rat. It was cool how he got. Just
thank all you teeny boppers for buying this shit so we could get Masterpiece.
Yeah, exactly.
Pretty much.
Thanks.
The Megatron's not too bad, but again, it's the Voyager class.
Yeah.
Yep.
Tank. Shockwave.
He did actually look pretty cool.
You get the deluxe version of Soundwave.
Now, this was one they just fucking shit the bed on, Soundwave.
No.
What were they thinking?
I still like the Human Alliance, but yeah. It's...
All right.
Starscream. Here you go, deluxe.
Big triangle.
You go deluxe, I'm getting it, too. For sure.
And hey, you guys want some Dinobots? Screw fans' toys. Screw all them. You get an Optimus Prime that can ride your luck.
Wait, we're getting anniversary figures of the last movie?
Yes, we are.
Wow. Oh, I guess, yeah.
It's just the Bayverse.
I will never forgive Michael Bay for this.
And it's great.
Just then, we want to call. The fifth move is when you stop forgiving him.
Miniature Bumblebee.
Oh,
yeah.
I could care less about any of the characters in the first ones. But,
and then we're getting a leader class, Prime. Basically, the Buster Optimus without the chrome.
You know, it's a pretty fun mold. I've got the Nemesis version, which is great, the Jetwing. But yeah,
it's a pain in the ass to transform.
Oh fuck yeah!
Yeah. Next up, we have Lao Kaiser.
I like. Okay, I need some info on this guy. Where is he being sold? Is he online exclusive, or is Toys R Us getting him?
Yeah.
That's right.
That was the answer. What?
No, I mean yes. I mean yes. If I want to know where you can get him at.
Okay, too. Good. Yeah. I'm with you.
I have no idea, to be honest with you. I didn't think he was going to be at Toys R Us.
He's on Amazon, right?
Yeah.
.com for not a nice price at all.
Yeah.
I didn't think he was a shared exclusive. I didn't think he was going to be an exclusive, per se. But
I thought Leo Kaiser's legs were turned. Like his
Sideways, right? Sideways.
Yeah, they are. But then he'd look too skinny. Yeah. He's not a runner.
Being that this is a Combined Wars figure, can you do that with the legs?
It's square pegs, so you can get away with it.
There we go. The repainted of Skylinks into Leozak.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's party.
I don't know.
Yeah, I just thought, hey, why not?
I kind of wish they'd rather they got one more use out of it. I know y'all probably
don't hate me,
but I'd have rather seen it.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
No, yeah. I was going to say, like, but on this one dude, isn't that a really good head sculpt for that character?
Drillhorn here?
Yeah, it's pretty solid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that Arms Micron figure is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Actually, now looking at Amazon, there's a pretty good G1 knockoff of Leo Kaiser on Amazon for $30.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry, Trent, for interrupting you. I didn't mean to.
No, that's cool. I was just going to say, I know y'all probably going to hate me, but for Leozak, I kind of wouldn't mind him giving one more use out of that silver boat for Leozak rather than Skylink. That's just me.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Mm. I agree with you. You're right.
Definitely. The Combiner Wars did knock it out of the park for the head sculpts.
That's what I was about to say, James.
Yeah, they nailed it. Got to give them props for that.
If there was one thing they did really well, it was that. The head sculpts were beautiful for the most
part. But what color of third-party feet do you buy?
Yeah, sure. I don't know. Just something.
Buy the Bruticus. That's a good question.
Yeah, get the Bruticus ones like James said.
Yeah.
Next up, Titan Return stuff. This was at New York Comic Con. I'm not going to show a lot of this stuff because... go check out the Roma Collectors YouTube channel. They did it. Do You Even Transform Bro last week and covered a lot of this. And we covered it again on ETR. So, but I'm just going to highlight some stuff. We know this is going to be the Astro Train mold. This is the Optimus Prime Triple Changer Laser.
Octane.
Yeah. I can't wait to have to buy the $200 Nemesis repaint from the Tokyo Toy Show of that one.
It's going to be good.
Tokyo Toy Show. Why did they do that with the head?
I don't know. Head.
Don't worry about it.
Yep.
Fuck. That jet move looks like shit.
Nailed it.
It does.
Yeah. It's great.
It's a typical triple.
They just need to upscale this to Masterpiece, and I'm putting that son of a bitch on this.
Yeah. Boom. Love it. But the repugnance.
Less paint apps, so I need less paint apps.
Yes. I like it's so small. It's a repugnus.
I love it. I like the Titan Masters. Oh, God. That mode is just mental.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta
it's give R.I.D.
It, you got to give it props for having three shit modes.
It's pretty good. All right, moving on to some better stuff.
Yeah, this one's not bad.
Right. We're looking at Black Shadow.
Yeah.
And I love... I'm not trying to shit on the fandom, but at times it's like, oh, I know what he's going to be. They're going to redeco that into what? What do you think? Durr. Overlord. I mean,
but you know, this is a good mold. For Hasbro, like I was on. Do you even transform, bro? There's like very little hollow points on him. He's a solid figure.
Yeah,
he looks good, and I love the fact that all the Phase Sixers are going to be the same size. They're all leader classes, so that's badass. Yep. Even though Overlord should be a tad bit bigger.
I like these like opposable cannons on his shoulders are pretty cool too. Yeah. They look like they rotate. Yeah. You know?
He's beautiful. It's a beautiful figure.
So this head is like the Galvatron where another piece folds up over top of it.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. It's cool.
And it looks good. I mean, there's the in-hand picture.
Yeah.
It looks like it fits on pretty nicely. We do get a base mode or a mock-up of one.
Yeah, and you get
so you can have it.
You know, there's five colors on that bot, like main colors, which is pretty decent.
We're not going to get a blue Bacchus because we don't care about that character ever.
Nobody gives a shit about that.
No. So, moving on. Broadside.
Hey, pretty heavy retool.
I do like it. It looks good. I do like the fact you get the little jets on a sprue.
I like the decals they put on the aircraft carrier, the airstrip, and the 36 is pretty cool. Mm-hmm. And I love his asymmetrical shoulders, actually. I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
There's his little Titan Master.
Solid.
And they're knocking it out the park, too. Again, it's head sculpts. Whoever designs that is doing really well.
They're really putting, you know, I'm noticing a lot more details, small details on the figures too. I mean, even Skylink's here. He's got a lot of molding, like specialty molding on him. He's pretty cool.
Now, what we're looking at here is a picture mock-up. It's not the exact, you know, real deal, but it doesn't stray too far off. Here he is compared to the original G1.
Which was the best.
That is. you know, Black Zarek, piss off. This guy right here. I don't need Fort Max. I don't need Grand Max. Any of that? No. About this dude.
Oh, did they not have the? Did they not have the rights to use 86? They had to give him 36.
I guess maybe, or there was someone at Hasbro or vice versa didn't know.
That was the year he came out, 86, too.
What'd you say, Russ?
Yeah, you think we're going to get a tidal wave out of them?
Yes.
Yes, probably. That's a good, good call. Good call.
My son would really like that figure because he really loved tidal wave.
Was there a G1 tidal wave toy?
I don't think so.
The only instance I remember Tidal Wave, he probably came up in Energon or RID or something. Yeah. I remember him from one of the PlayStation games.
We got Bron.
Yeah.
That Bron's dope.
He's awesome, man.
Yeah.
I love his little shield.
The arms bother me on these. I don't know why. I can't let it go, but I hate the arms.
You hate the arms. Would you rather have the G1 arms?
No, but I'm just talking about like that hollow bit on everything in Titans Returns. Like these are like Galvatron has the same kind of like hollow, you know what I mean?
No excuse there because they don't fold out, right? It's not like the hands fall out. So why is there a hollow point? That's a good point.
Yeah, well, it's a kid's toy.
It is, and that's what they're going to say. It's
good really head sculpt.
If you want something better, you know, I'd get Brawny.
Oh, wait, you can't. It's gone.
Yeah. Well, he's coming back.
Mm-hmm.
There's Preceptor. Not bad. Finally, we get him back in his original mode.
Yeah. I think his bot mode is the weakest mode, but the other modes are pretty cool.
I hate to say, but I agree with you.
Yeah. Yeah.
The microscope, yeah, that looks pretty
fun. The microscope's bang on. I hope you can see through it, like the G1.
That's what I heard.
I've heard it.
It has like a, you know, a point 2 magnification or something like that. Probably.
That would be awesome. I agree with you that the bot mode is probably the weakest one, but it's not hateful.
No. I mean, compared to the other figures in the line, there's a lot more hollowness to it in the thighs and the arms and even the under behind the shoulders. There's tons of hollow points, which is kind of scary.
And, yeah, now that you say that, I hate it.
That's out the window. That shit is broke. Come on.
Come on.
Shit, bring the robot
just a little pack of fillers.
Mm-hmm.
For us collectors, we can just pop them in there. That'd be great.
It's interesting. You look at his gun. They put the little tripod legs on it as if it's sniper rifle, which I guess is a nod to the IDW Perceptor.
Yeah, especially when you have a little tight mask that can sit in it too.
Question about his microscope and robot mode. I wonder if it can come down just a little bit further instead of being so far high above his head like this.
Yeah, it's pretty awkward. Sure, especially because it's so big. Compared to his head. It's like bigger than his arm, right? So it's kind of awkward.
Here is the head sculpt.
Good head sculpt.
Yeah.
Good old professor.
Yeah.
All right, and here he is next to the G1.
Love G1. So.
There we go. Moving on to Double Cross.
Double Cross.
He's cool.
I think they killed it.
Yeah
he looks good.
Now, is he going to get Voyager or is he Deluxe?
He looks Deluxe.
Deluxe, okay.
I mean, he'll look cool with Mind Wipe and stuff, which is rad. But he's another one they did great on as far as hollow points go and everything. He's really good. Great head sculpt.
I do love his
the eye patch head. On the little guy.
The white Leo that they made him after.
That's super cool.
That is badass.
I didn't notice that eye patch. That's like dope.
Everything that they're doing, that Hasbro's doing for Titans Return, is just a really nice nod to the Japanese G1.
Okay, what's his head like? You know, I know he's a two-headed dragon, but his head looks like a cat almost, like a lion.
It's White Leo.
Like White Leo, okay. Yeah, he's got the little paws.
It's from Beastformers. If you watch the Headmasters Japanese series,
right, and like,
they become the kind of bodyguards for the Beastformers.
Like, even on his feet, they're like paws, you know? They went that extra little step that it's they crazy. Obviously did not have to do at all. So that's
I'd be curious to see if they did that with Rapungus and
they probably did if that was the case, because they'll just reuse those legs.
Probably.
If Hasbro had made this dude a Voyager or a friggin' leader, I wouldn't be looking at that third party one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do wish he had been a Voyager though.
Yes, you know, Voyager would have been nice.
I was in Walmart today, and I saw the leader Soundwave. I do not think that's a good-looking figure at all. Seeing it in person, man. Like, the blaster's not bad. It's pretty good. I think that Soundwave is shit.
It is. Especially, but again, you're going to get the same size, which is nice, for the Seekers and Megatron for Combiner Wars.
Yeah, I mean, and then all the gold paint wears off, and then...
There's the G1. Why did they put the Decepticon on? That's cool. There, but... There he is. Moving on to good old Trigger Happy.
Trigger Happy. Yes. This jet mode is awesome.
It's
awesome. Like, all those guns, that is a cool fucking toy. No kids going to know who Trigger Happy is, but they're gonna. It's fucking cool.
Looking forward to Misfire and Slugslinger.
That's their best deluxe right there.
I wish they split like
the head. The head is fucking cool.
Yeah, it's on point.
I haven't even looked at this closely. That's a good figure.
I don't know.
What is up, Jisk? Yo,
Gabatron.
What's happening?
Sorry. Yeah, they nailed it. They did a good job on the G1.
Yeah, it looks great.
I guess you just don't get the Target Master, though.
Yeah, I can live without that.
Yeah, me too.
All right, moving on. Six shot. I just threw this in there. Just
summary mode. You know, they put the gun mode.
Submarine mode.
Tank mode.
It's not a gun. It's an upside down submarine.
You know, they did all right.
It's good for a brick or mortar, you know, kids toy line.
Legit. Yep. Yep.
You know, it's not going to compete with, let's say, Hexatron.
No. You know,
But it's cool that they decided to do this character.
If I had a kid, I'd be like, yo, you need to know who Scott is and buy this toy. I'll buy you this toy because this is sick shit and he's dope.
Yeah, this is going under my kid's Christmas tree.
For sure.
For you.
I give him stuff.
That's really cool.
After I inspect it and transform it and display it for a couple of months. Yeah.
No,
like, I wanna give him this and the instruction booklet and be like, hey, this is what you need to do.
I think they nailed every mode. Like when you compare every mode to its G1 counterpart, it's like it's a really G1 updated figure. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just never thought they would do some of these guys again. I'm surprised.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool. Next up we have just some comparison picks for Hot Rod. Yeah. G1, 2006 classics, and then the new Titans Return. Looks good.
It looks all right. It really reminds me of Prime Wheeljack.
Yeah, they just need to. They didn't even. God, you know, Hasbro boys that do the pictures and transformations really need to, like, spoilers up there. This guy's a spoiler up there.
Yeah.
I think this rotates.
I think they should hire somebody who likes Transformers.
Someone who's a fan, someone who knows, not some
amateur.
They could gain a lot from doing that.
Here's the Platinum Edition movie little 5-pack that they're doing. You get to see that they did redeco the characters.
So is that the same cup mold? Yeah. He looks beefier somehow, but it's the same, right?
Yeah, it's the same.
It's just the angle of the photo.
I love that
mold. Honestly, the RC is the only one that looks better.
Yep. It's basically the Takara Legends color scheme almost.
Right.
I kind of like the blur better.
I don't mind that they...
Yeah, the blur is probably a little bit better too.
You know, for IDW figures, I don't mind they knock down the yellow on Springer. It kind of looks cool having like kind of a gold thing, but I have to figure that it's not like I'm going to buy another.
Yeah, right.
This is going to be a platinum pack with a leader figure and a Voyager figure, 3 deluxes. What's it going to be like? $100?
$179.99.
But did that first Ultra Magnus come with the Minimus Ambus too?
It did indeed.
I just see it in the photo. I didn't know if the first one had
Magnus cannot even hold his fucking guns. They just his fingers are so loose, they just fall out of his hand.
Minimus came with the first one and they got Alpha Trion.
The Takara had Alpha Trion. Right. But like the only mold out of this that I have is the cup and mine's broken, so I might get this.
You gotta get that Aegir head is so awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, but it's not going to color match this. I'm going to have to paint
it. No, exactly. It's not going to color match.
True.
I'm too fucking lazy for that shit, bro.
I know someone's excited about this, dude.
I wouldn't care.
Primal Selfish.
Here's another one I can't wait to wait.
We're getting a Victor. Let me see what it needs to be for the iTunes. I know it's hard.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's all quiet. We're looking at.
Did Alpha Trion have that like ornate molding in his chest?
I don't know, but we're looking at Leo Prime or Lio Convoy.
The more important question is: did Alpha Trion have that fucking awesome codpiece?
Yeah, man. with the pubes coming out the sides, both ways.
Looks good. I do like this. A little love to the beast.
The one thing that sucks about it is a sword tail.
Yeah.
And find something. They do something.
It's like boing. But pretty decent.
Yeah.
It's a good repaint, and we knew it was coming. So.
But when you're comparing it to this one on the left, like he has way less articulation in lion mode. like those legs don't have side kickouts and stuff, you know?
No.
The one on the left looks better though.
Oh, it does look way better.
Looks better than the original.
I think the legends, the one on the right, the robot mode looks better. And then the lion mode looks better on the other one.
See, I think it's better on the left all around.
All around. We never got a good black repaint of that one. We got kind of like a half-hearted Nemesis version. I never bought it. Oh, the leg.
Next up, we saw this on ETR and probably even Transform Row, but there's Trypticon's leg. And so it's coming. It wasn't, you know, a farce.
And it's got the walking mechanics in it, it looks like. And, you know, somebody photoshopped a sort of half-scale shitty version of it just to see how big it would be, and it's impressively large.
Yeah. Like, I keep forgetting, what scale is that six shot? Is that
leader?
Leader? Okay,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
With his exploded head.
Well, that's the thing. Like, the leaders, don't they all have like that face mask thing for?
Yeah, the fold down to complete the helmet.
It'd be cool to have a whole bunch of those headmasters next to that Trypticon. Like, just that scale looks.
Yeah. That's why I'm buying the Titan Masters and nothing else, because I'm in for the Titan figures, and I'm in for the Titan Master figures just to have the little guys to play in the bases with, sort of thing. You know, they're doing on those two fronts the most, I feel.
Clobber is really fun.
Yeah, Clobber's super awesome.
Oh, all right, up next is TFC Toys' Turtler or...
Poises.
Turtler?
Turtler is their...
Turtler.
Turtler?
Is the Japanese
one. This looks good.
Yeah, I'm on the fence about this guy. They really went super techy with each, like, really over-molded almost. You know, a lot of...
Like that Warbitron style.
You know?
Yeah.
This one looks cool as shit to me.
They all look fucking cool, and Piranacon looks cool, but I just, you know, putting him beside Feral Rex and Warbitron and even... Abominus, the Unique Toys Abominus.
But if you put Piranacon against any of the other combiners, he looks kind of goofy, no matter how badass he was in the show.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah. He looks much different.
I
love Piranacon too, and I love all the recolors they've done with, like, the Beast Wars 2.
And that gun has purple chrome, bro. Come on.
Fact. And, you know, there's some cool, the clear yellow, the light piping, like, and even his kneecaps are like a clear plastic, which is really cool. So is the claws as well. You know, they're doing some really fucking cool stuff. Maybe after I see a full color combined mode, I'm going to be like, fuck, I got to buy this. But
this, you've already seen that, but
this guy's the torso. Sorry, Jamin. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. Everyone's been interrupting me. So fuck this shit. Gonna be a closed hangout from now on.
So there's six bots to this set, and the gimmick is that any one of them except for the torso can become a gun. Is that what it is? Like, it's kind of Scramble City.
Are they doing a six?
Yeah, I thought they were doing six.
They got it. Six, right?
Really? They are doing six? Okay.
I thought so. I may be wrong. I thought so.
I feel like the last one is gonna be the gun, right?
Well, they would have to. I was just going to say they have to do six, because didn't the last one, the little shark or piranha one that they released, also had a gun mode?
Yeah, they all had the target master.
Yeah.
So I think, why would you even have that gimmick if you weren't going to do six of them?
Six of them, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, the only repaint that didn't have the gun mode, the sixth bot, was the Beast Wars one, the white repaint of Piranacon.
Yeah, in the States, we didn't get all six, did we, or was it vice versa with Takara? Because we got,
I'm not sure.
Until we got the reissue.
Yeah, I remember as a kid having some of these, but not all of them.
He is cool looking.
That turtle head's really cool in his beast mode.
He looks so Gamera like.
He looks like Death Charge.
Yeah.
Yeah. Torso mode. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, it's true.
He looks good, but after seeing the shit that they did to Lyokaiser, which I want more than the King Poseidon, I don't trust him.
Yeah.
Floppy mess. And now you're going to give him a 6-member to be a gun?
Is he going to be able to hold weight? An entire masterpiece figure to be a gun, essentially.
So it's like,
yeah.
I don't know about that. $100 yeah. pop. I'm glad TFC Toys is tackling this character, but it just seems like they need to engineer it a little bit better and stop doing the same thing they did back in the day with Hercules.
Yeah, I think the head should be bigger too.
That's the thing. They don't really have to, though. You know what I mean? Like, they can just kind of they can keep making the same kind of inferior product because they're making these combiners A, pretty fast, and B, they're making combiners that no one else has even touched.
No one else, yeah.
And they're doing Road Caesar too, which I'm like, oh man, that's another.
So
one.
I mean, they got their money regardless.
Getting them. There's no competition for them, so they're okay. Yeah.
All right. Up next is another TFCon exclusive. We get the Diclone version of the Lost Exorealm Severo, their Grimlock. Finally, I get the blue crotch version. You don't get a throne, unfortunately, but you do get a driver, which is actually a new mold. I believe it's a new mold. And you get their weapon. His weapons are now a blue translucent plastic instead of a red.
Right. And this figure is also going to be in the custom class?
Yep, we're getting there.
But
Sorry, man.
So, James, do you have somebody grabbing this for you already?
Yeah, no, not yet. I need to figure out how much it's going to be because there's a little bit of other stuff I think I may want to pick up. I'm thinking about getting the Carnifex at TFCon because you get the hook.
Yeah.
I mean, is it worth it? No, but, you know.
I mean, shit, if you can get an extra accessory.
Why not? For the same price?
Yeah, you might as well.
Does the MMC's Impactor have that hook as well? I feel like I've seen that hook somewhere else.
No, you can only get it with the...
It's only card effect.
Yeah.
He has the hook, but he doesn't have the line and all that cool shit that goes with it. But this looks good. It took them forever. Thank you, Bands Project. I think I want the custom class one more, which is going to be a bitch to obtain. Because I have to buy that off of someone who's putting it together and all that, but we'll see. But it looks good. They should have redone his eyes, so it's a little more life.
Yeah.
Dino mode, they did do something with the thigh region. I believe they redid something. I don't know. I think it's just to redeco.
Is the tail supposed to extend a little bit more on that?
No.
That's no. It's just short like that?
He's so cute. He's like a little
tail. He has like a normal looking head, torso, then explosion.
The thunder thighs, and then
Don't skip leg day.
And there's the new driver, right there, which is nice. Huh. Which you didn't get in that 6-pack, I don't think. That was an exclusive to FP Core. Just redecos of these guys. I love these guys. I have them littered all over my refrigerator.
Do you know how many pieces they have on this one?
Like probably how many enough.
Oh, okay, it's not
probably enough for the people.
I remember that someone came in there at what was it, Charlotte or something, or maybe it was Chicago. I don't know. Whenever the swoop came out, someone came in there and just bought all of them. But now you can obtain that swoop and all the rest of them for like a discounted price on all the e-tailers. So I don't know. There they are with the team. It's okay. But here is the custom class. They are doing the G2 blue version of Grimlock or Severo. So that looks nice. I do like that.
It's pretty cool.
So that's what they're going to, that's the end result. You get that.
Yeah.
This. Okay.
And this is pretty damn sweet. I mean, this is a really nice figure to do as a custom class.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't it $50? Isn't that what the class is?
Damn, that's cheap. That's even better than Bakkon.
I thought it was cheap. I thought that's what Ace was saying, is that it was $50, but maybe.
Because Bakkon's $120, and to get the figure without it being painted was like $75 or something like that.
I'm going to look on their site right now and see what it says.
I would think it had to be at least a couple of figures. I mean,
for a Voyager, class figure two.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm on board.
He is Voyager sized?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a big dude. All of the Dinobots are that size.
Alright, yeah. So let's see.
But you're also going to be spending a lot of time in this in the custom class, probably all day. If you
that's
end
your,
up doing
that's it. Your Sunday, yeah.
It doesn't show actually. You click on the link and it just gives you the classes for it. I mean, it just gives you the cost for admission, but it doesn't give you what the class is.
Can you get the figure and dip and ship it to Seattle?
I wish. I would love that.
Well, it's not gonna be. It's not gonna be painted though.
No. Yeah,
that's the whole thing. Is like you're gonna get that other figure, and if you take the class, then it'll wind up. This is the end result, hopefully.
And I wonder who's doing the sponsorship. I mean, I know that Captured Prey's done it in the past. I thought Orson's done it in the past, and it's cool that they're bringing it back. It's a nice little feature. And since there's no more BotCon, that's what BotCon used to do. So I like that. But all right, moving on. We know. I think J. Ruse and Ace are all about this. The Scorponok, which is leader class, or not leader class, excuse me, legends class, but it'll fit in. I mean, it's essentially Voyager size.
It's the Iron Factory one. It's tall. I mean, it's tall in comparison to all those other Iron Factory ones.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. Dude.
Yeah, it looks really good.
It's cool.
It's a weird one. You can't really screw up Scorponok.
Oh, I don't know. I bet you could.
You could.
You have to be fucking come toy on, world. Hasbro Titan class, Scorponok.
You have to be Toy World. Come on.
He was probably my favorite. Like I guess Titan, if you will. He's my favorite. I voted for him. Hasbro, I guess. Yeah. I hope Hasbro does one. I hope they don't fuck it up. So.
He's a hybrid of the Triptychon.
Man.
It looks good for its size.
Damn.
Yeah,
that looks awesome right there.
Yeah.
Did a good job.
Looks amazing.
Some toys needs a child.
Does anybody know what this is going for? Cost-wise?
I have no idea. I forgot.
I want to say 80, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not that expensive.
That's not bad at all, actually. Wow. Okay.
Base mode looks good.
Yeah,
but would you want this in this size? I mean, if you're going for the whole Iron Factory, wouldn't you want the Make Toys one? Isn't that the actual size?
Oh, you want it to be in scale?
Yeah, I mean, well, isn't that the whole point? If you're buying these Iron Factory things, wouldn't you want them to be in scale with your City Bots?
Yeah,
I'm just asking. I don't know if this is.
He would, but like in IDW, I mean, Scorponok was the same size as like Ultra Magnus, and right? All that.
I gotcha.
Yeah. So, I mean,
I'll hold out for a big ass one, so to speak.
Anyway. So you just need to ask Anna for the Make Toys.
Yeah, I'm like, Anna, please, she's like, go F yourself.
Yeah, that's awesome. All right, next up, we're looking at DX9, I believe. Yeah, this is DX. Iron Factory does the War Within. Follow Cybertron stuff. So this is the DX9's G1 version of Dinobots. So we're looking at Swoop. I don't know their third party name.
Warren Pocket.
Yeah, but what the actual bot's name?
Oh, sorry, yeah. My bad.
No, it's all good. I mean, he cleans up nicely for a small figure.
Yeah, he's really cool.
Balancing.
Answer. All right.
Grimlock, we must go that way.
Yeah, man.
Iron Man pose, thank God he can do that.
Do they sell these individually or do they sell these as a set when they come out?
I think this is individual.
They'll all be individual? Yeah, okay.
I thought so. The other one was a set, I know that.
But yeah, the Iron Factory one?
Yeah.
But those were all fucking War Within ones.
Cool. They looked alright, but I heard they weren't very good. I heard they weren't very good.
I mean, it's straight up G1.
Yeah,
there's not a lot going on here.
I know. The only thing that scares me about these when DX9 does it is you know that, like, how long until you get a KO, you're not a KO upsize, but like an upsize version, and they try and pass it off as an MP.
That is very true. They do that.
I don't think they'll bother with Dinobots at this point. With all the
Slag looks pretty good.
Yeah, yep. This thing looks great.
Yeah, they're super cool looking.
But like, since everybody's already released their Dinobots, do you think they're just gonna release this set and then upsize them in a couple of months?
No.
I don't think so either. The only way it's beneficial to them is to do the price point, and now that you have Fans Toys potentially redoing them all again at that 135, but you can't compete with that.
No.
Well, they're lucky enough to do their Mitron, I think. Those Megatron. Other than that, I don't think they're going to do it. Sludge.
Sludge.
He looks bow-legged.
What was up with the two different legs?
What?
I think it's just not folded. Yeah, I think it's just not folded back all the way.
All right. Sorry.
Former Hasbro information.
These things are cool. Like I've been tempted on like this scale. Like I just like these Legends figures and you get a whole bunch of them. But then I don't go in on it because then I'd have to buy these City Bots and I don't want to do that.
That's what I'd ask you. Would you buy those?
I would have to, man. It just makes them look that much cooler. But I like that. I just like the scale and that.
And so would you buy two?
No, if I went this route, no, I wouldn't.
So far from like what we've seen, they look so much better in Dino mode.
Yeah,
they do. But for Dinobots, do they shine more in Dino mode, or you think they should shine more in Dino mode? Put it that way.
Yeah,
I don't know. Yeah. I think you. I don't think so. I think usually in the cartoon, you don't see them in Dino mode as much. You see them more in robot mode, so I think robot mode's actually more.
Yeah, I disagree with that. I think you see them more in Dino mode in the cartoon.
Yeah, they attack more and they get into Dino mode when they're attacking, it seems like.
In season 3, you definitely see them in Dino mode more.
Oh, yeah, they're hanging out in the freaking pond.
Yeah.
Is that their Grimlock or is that Warbitron Grimlock? I doubt it would be the Warbitron. Never mind. It's got to be.
Withdrawn.
Yeah, I was like, you know what? That was dumb.
And that's hulky, right?
Yeah. Where's the eyes? They need the little googly eyes.
Oh, no. It's not the same.
These googly eyes.
Matt's been showing it for the past 5 minutes.
I just love this guy.
Yeah, that's nice. It didn't do a snarl.
It looks good, except whoever's Grimlock that is on the smaller side.
Yeah, they.
I'm telling you, I think it's that Warbitron one.
It might be.
Painted differently because I'm looking at it, and it looks the same.
There's the hybrid.
Oh yeah, hybrid stuck in there.
Geez, that Ironhide's pretty terrible. Legend, huh?
Blue streak. Look at that prowl. Well, blue streak, I guess.
Blue streak, yeah. Wow. Got a little flat, didn't he?
Oh, well. All right. Moving out of Transformers into other action figures, collectibles, and all that type of stuff. Taking a look at Entertainment Earth exclusive 4-pack. This is the Star Wars Black Series Clone Trooper set. This is a 4-pack of blue, red, yellow, and green. So the 501st, Coruscant Guard, the 212, yeah, and 442nd. So not bad. No, we got Cody. No Rex yet. Thank you, Hasbro.
Anybody that's in for these, when you buy these, do you open these or do you leave these sealed?
I open them.
Yeah. Would you buy two, though? I mean, is this something that is even worth keeping sealed?
I open them all. This is a troop build, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd open the hell out of these.
Okay. I don't know.
I did that with the Evolution pack, too, the Stormtrooper Evolution, which was great. Plus, these are phase two, which we only got one phase two so far in. Out of just normal Stormtrooper, Clone Trooper guy from that Evolution pack. And I know Cody's phase two, but still.
I think the kind of the book box set style boxing is pretty cool. Is this like a trifold thing or are they just lined up close?
No, it's a trifold.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah,
it is nice. And it's Velcroed and all that. Oh, it's pretty sweet.
That's dope.
They're right there all lined up. Again, they're probably just doing the shock trooper from the Battlefront.
Black and a pink.
The yellow and the green are pretty much the same, I guess, but the other two are more unique.
Yeah, like the 501.
I do too.
Except there's no rocks, bitches.
Yeah.
Not bitter. There they are in nice pose. There they are with the rest of the clones. Oh, shit.
They feel like Power Rangers to me.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why I said
that. I was just thinking it.
Come on.
Clone
Wars. It makes sense.
For the Empire, go!
My palms, Rex, Cody.
Kimberly.
I think this is a second.
I like the white dude on the end that's just like, yo.
Yo, I'm playing. I'm a shiny.
All he needs is kind of like a coat down from the bottom and he can squat. Yeah.
So, and then here's the other Entertainment Earth exclusive from last year. Which was the Sand Trooper, the Lava Red Stormtrooper, TIE Pilot, and a little
Black
RD. Black RD, I guess you could call it.
Yeah.
Nemesis R2.
Yeah.
All right, next up we have the Star Wars Black Series AT-AT Pilot, or AT-AT, depending on how you want to call it.
I like to call it Pilote de AT-AT.
Pilote
de AT-AT. For sure. AT-AT.
This doesn't mean we're getting a Black Series 6-inch AT-AT. That would be cool if we were.
Yeah.
Big motherfucker.
I don't know why they just did the TIE pilot. It would make sense to do it.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
After Rogue One came out.
Fucking huge.
Be like 2.5 feet tall.
Dude, that TIE fighter's if that scale that way, it would be huge.
Yeah. And then you gotta think about how wide it would be too.
Oh man, if they made that, able to walk, I'd ride that son of a bitch. Go get the mail. Where are you going? I'm taking my AT-AT for a walk.
It's not always the length. Sometimes it's the girth.
Yeah.
But really good detail on the paint apps here.
Yeah, it looks really nice. Oh, the head looks, great on it.
Now we have the Black Series C-3PO with red arm.
That's how I knew it was him.
Yeah.
I still want to know where the hell that came from.
Yeah, does anyone know the story behind that? Yeah, they come out with that. Yeah, that's why the hell he has a red arm.
Yeah, it had to do with some other protocol droid that was like bad, and then they got together. It's a comic book, so the other protocol droid was bad, and then they got into a situation where that protocol droid sacrificed himself for 3PO and told him to take his arm.
Oh, wasn't Droid Tales?
No, it's Marvel Comics.
Marvel.
Yeah, the new Marvel shit.
Mm.
Oh, cool. Okay. Was that like a prequel to Force Awakens?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And next is Director Krennic.
That's pretty cool. I wouldn't mind that one.
Yeah.
Just directing shit.
Is there a figure of this guy ever, even in the first? Or is this is a Rogue One character?
This is a Rogue One character.
Okay.
Rogue One, yeah.
I buy it for myself and then they get taken.
Now, with the Rogue One figures, I notice a lot of people are buying that, I don't know his name, that very tall black droid.
K2SO.
He's new to Rogue One, right?
Yeah.
Is he going to be the new Phasma? Everybody bought Phasma. She's in the movie for 2 seconds.
No, I think this thing has a pretty big role.
Okay.
Yeah, you see him in a lot of the scenes.
Yeah.
The toy is great. I was looking at it today, but yeah.
And if you didn't happen to get the San Diego Comic-Con old Obi-Wan Kenobi, well, here you go. You just don't get the little hologram of Leia, table, whatever it was.
De-exclusivized.
It's something Hasbro is doing now as of late. We see in the Marvel Legends game. Now we're seeing it in Star Wars.
Gotta get my hands on this one. That's nice. I like that.
Oh, Ben.
The cloth robe actually looks pretty decent.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
And he does look good.
He does look great.
Man. The face is good, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That big ear, though.
Yeah, for real.
What? Yeah, I never knew Obi-Wan was a fucking Vulcan.
Jedi sensitive ears. Oh.
And if you look at his knuckles on that hand sticking out real fast, it looks like he's got six fingers.
Wow.
For a minute. I'm like, wait a minute.
I can't count.
All right. Well, I'm going to look at that figure really strangely.
Six knuckle.
Oh. See, this is where the cloth clothes don't work as well.
This is the moneymaker right here.
Yeah.
We're looking at Princess Leia Organa.
Why are her face sculpts so bad?
Dude,
it's Gary Fisher aged so
well. She looks very old head sculpt-wise.
That's the thing. Like, she's such a popular character, and like the last two Leia, they had to send the first one back to be resculpted, and now we're getting this one, and look at her.
Yeah, she doesn't look that great. I mean, she looks okay, but she just looks like your cheesy 3¾-inch toy.
I think they just put a white robe over the slave Leia they're not allowed to sell anymore.
How many guys do you think are going to try and like see what's, I wonder what's
under. I mean, that's, I'm wondering.
I know at least one.
I wonder what is under that.
I'm curious.
Oh, man.
I mean, they have.
She has a Wookiee body underneath.
Shout out to Kors.
It's just you and me, Leia. How you doing? Yep. I am going to address you with my eyes. Next up is the fan's choice, Darth Revan.
Oh,
this is going to be the most sought after. Yeah. Hopefully, we're all going to hit up Chris Pinkerton like crazy.
Yeah. We can find him, man.
He looks pretty cool.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, that looks awesome.
Look at that.
Tattered robes.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
His hood kind of looks a little goofy.
Oh, come on, don't spoil it.
Great Sith woman, badass.
Yo!
Oh my god!
And what is he? Is he from Rogue One as well, or is he
Knights of the Old Republic?
Knights of the Old Republic. I'm pretty sure I've seen him as well.
Old school.
Red and purple.
I like that they at least make the figures like in the same style as everything else. You know what I mean? They don't do so, you know, like even Knights of the Old Republic looks a little different. This one. They kind of made it that way, but
having just said what you said, this one looks like it's straight out of
That's what I thought. Clone Wars. I thought this one, I was like, wait a minute.
We're taking a look at Sabine Wren now from Rebels.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah. Little helmet.
She looks great. You
know, she looks better there than she does in that package.
Oh man.
Space boots.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, they've done a good job with taking any of these animated characters that never had a real person portraying them. Really trying to make them look like a person portrayed them. You know what I mean? They've done okay with that. The Kanan figure is great. I love it. I think it's fantastic. So
yeah, I do like the fact that the antenna can be posable.
Yeah,
that's kind of cool.
Nice detail.
The Scarif Stormtrooper, or they were calling it the Shore Trooper, or whatever.
Scarif.
The colorful Stormtrooper. Nice pastels. I like it.
It's like a semi-casual Stormtrooper. Got some pants on.
It's the formal. And here is the Snowtrooper. This one I'll army build the hell out of. I've always loved this one.
I like the cream-colored elements.
Yeah, he looks. I like him better than the other one for sure.
A little paint on the boots wouldn't hurt.
I hated
him
when I was a kid.
True.
Somebody watching the show, or what's going on?
I don't know. I hear something in the background.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. That maybe I'll kill my mic a bit. That might be my girlfriend.
Does anybody else think that this should have been all white and not that cream color?
It just saves us from getting it yellowed. Maybe.
You're not really hiding in the snow at that point. It's fucking boots on that yellow ass fucking pants.
And there's got some detail on the backpack, which is the same backpack we've seen.
Yeah.
On the Snowtrooper. All right, here's Baze from Rogue One. Sporting a fucking ass nice gun.
I know, look at that thing.
Bishop's gun.
And we have the Blind Master. Cheer it.
Blind Donnie Yen.
Donnie. I'm pronouncing their names right, but I don't know. And we got episode 4, Darth Vader.
Oh, wow.
Look, it's my package.
We have the card pieces.
Well, my eyes were right to it. I was like, God damn, dude, holy shit. Vader got it going on.
Vader has got it.
Yeah.
Hey, Russ, I think you need to check your mic connection. You're scrambling out a little bit.
Oh, that's been all show, man.
You sound like a droid from Star Wars now. It's not bad.
All right, next up we have the Disney Store exclusive 5-pack. These are a little bit larger than your standard Black Series figures, or more like 7-inch die-cast. Yeah, I'm not too happy with this one, this set. Plus, it's a lot of stuff we've already got.
Yeah.
But that Finn looks really like, I don't know, shocked. A little too white.
Dude, that Finn looks like Token from South Park.
He does.
The heavy gunner's nice. The flame trooper, yeah, we've already gotten Phasma, and I don't need another Kylo Ren. So,
do you guys wish that the Black Series came with those stands?
Yes.
Or, yeah, I think
that'd be cool.
Yeah, that would make it more. I mean, I don't want to say like masterpiece, but like more collector. I guess
a little more upscaled.
Yeah.
Make you feel like you're getting more bang for your buck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, the packaging's nice because it's resealable and it's sleek. But yeah, a stand, I mean, come on. It shouldn't cost that much. And you also get the screw holes, which is always pleasant, but not like you're going to be displaying them with their ass shown to you. So,
do the Black Series not have those screw holes like that?
No. Well, this is because it's die cast.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So. And you said these are shitty, right, James?
Grievous was the bane of my existence. Some of them are nice, but they don't scale. If she was all chromed, then yeah, I would totally pick up this Phasma.
But like,
but this kid is happy because he got
it. He's got a giant Phasma now. It looks like a Wookiee put on Phasma's costume. He's like a head taller than everybody else.
And Finn still looks like, I don't want that kid touching me.
I just like that he's playing with these figures in like some steelworks factory.
Yeah, just take your kid to work there.
Just play over there, honey. You'll be fine. Yeah. Okay.
Don't worry about the sparks. Okay.
And then we have the AT-AT. This is the one that's going to be motorized, I believe, controlled through your phone.
Oh yeah, I remember this.
The app. It's got the Nerf gun feature, so it has a little Nerf missiles. So that's cool. Safety.
You'll notice they remolded Trypticon's legs for this one.
Trypticon's
a fucking AT-AT.
Mm-hmm. So this fits the 3¾ figures?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's why Trypticon's going to be a fucking Triceratops now.
Yeah, probably. But you can. There's a lot of features to this, but again, the price point of this. I don't know. It's probably going to be close to $150, $200. I mean, the Millennium Falcon, the Legacy Millennium Falcon came out around $130, I think.
That seems standard for any large Star Wars shit, though, anyway.
But, like, man,
expensive.
Yeah, we'll see. All right, moving on. There's a Toys R Us exclusive 6-pack. So if you didn't like buying these guys individually, you can buy them as a group. There you go.
Yeah.
You get... Poe, Finn, you get the Riot First Order Stormtrooper, you get a TIE Pilot, Poe, Kylo Ren, and
Right.
What in this set has Nerf, or is that something for another box on the bottom?
That's another box.
Okay. Yeah, the box. You know what's funny? These are all the guys that are fucking peg warming in the store right now.
Yep.
Yeah, they are.
all together now.
Yeah. Just when you thought Walmart was not gonna be doing carrying the 3¾-inch Black Series figures, We actually are continuing on. We're getting a Sergeant Jin Erso.
That's cool.
With nice. Build a rifle, which is nice. Just like in the movie. And you can army build the Imperial Death Trooper.
That's cool.
Nice.
Those
are cool.
Surprised this wasn't out during their little Rogue Friday instead of the Ahsoka and all that, but who knows. All right, next up, PlayArt's Kai, my love and bane because they're getting too expensive. But taking a look at the Gears of War 3, Marcus Fenix, $200 coming out January, I believe.
Are you buying this, Shane?
Yeah, I am, actually. I'm going to go next to my Halo stuff. I thought, what the hell? Why stop now? Why stop?
Yeah, for real at that point.
Yeah, it's like, who cares?
You know they keep making figures because they're like, there's one guy out there who keeps buying them. Let's keep on making them.
It's all your fault. They've masked his joints really well as like ball joints on his wrist and stuff. Like, that's tight.
Oh, yeah. They're taking cues. I mean, like from Metal Gear, Venom Snake, not the sneaking suit, but the first one, oh, man, that... The joints are well hidden. It looks really nice. They've taken cues from that. I don't think it justifies the $199 price point because it's the same size, same accessory pieces, stand, all that type of shit. But yeah, it looks good.
Now, are you buying this because you care about Gears of War or are you buying this to complete a line?
This is the first in their line. But I like Gears of War. It was one of the reasons why I bought the Xbox 360 back in the day. But I don't know how to word myself, but
you're a player's guy completist.
I'm a player's guy completist, but I like to have like representation for characters from whatever, whether it's a game, anime, movie, cartoon, whatever, in the like my little display area. Like I have a video game shelf, so it has Halo, it has Devil May Cry, Resident Evil, Gears of War stuff, but. I just have all that type of stuff. So it's a nice representation. I'm not going the route of Hot Toys to have like the best cream of the crop and all that type of stuff, but I'll go this far.
Yeah.
And I get the fact I'm spending the same amount of money as
I was to say, shit, you're almost spending Hot Toys money on it.
Yeah, I was going to say.
But, I mean, there's the accessory pieces. I do love the blood on the gun.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. Just like the prop replica gun that I have.
It does look nice.
Yeah,
definitely. So, all right.
Now, does that stand come with him?
Yes. All PlayArt's Kai figures now come with the stand. And it's a hit or miss. Some people hate the stand because you have to tighten it because it gets loose. But, hey, at least you have the option to tighten it instead of it's just a floppy mess. But it's better than nothing also.
Yeah.
But, yeah. All right, next up is the NYCC exclusive Batman versus Superman Black and White Edition. They did the same thing with Man of Steel, and they're doing it with BVS. So, there you go. $200, probably. $150, maybe. Next up is the PlayArt's Kai Tetsu Nomura Joker figure. He designed the Catwoman back there, and he also designed the Batman, and now we're getting a Joker. And it looks pretty damn good. $200 though.
Yeah, that's crazy looking though.
But yeah, look at that.
How many heads does he have? He has like 7 heads though.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got the red hood. He's got like the Jester Joker. He's got a Demon Joker.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I like it.
Damn.
Yeah, that's a lot. Damn.
And that's pretty cool.
Yeah, there's even like an Arkham Joker.
We've seen these already at San Diego Comic Con and numerous times. This is part of the PlayArt's Kai Batman Rogues Gallery. We're getting a Two-Face, we're getting a Joker, but they announced we are getting a Mr. Freeze. That looks pretty damn sweet. Can't wait to see it all colored up.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be really dope. Colored up red eyes and frosty.
Just like that, I kind of wish they wouldn't color it up. That looks badass just the way it is.
Again, it's got a $200 price.
Man, I might have to get into these.
And just like my little Simba from KFC, I have to now just have a picture of Player Sky Wolverine. Because I'm looking forward to getting this guy.
Is this their first Marvel?
No.
Okay. But in this style, though, or no?
No.
Okay.
But it's finally we're getting a non-Avenger and Spider-Man.
Yeah. Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah.
So we're getting Wolverine and we're getting Deadpool, which is cool.
They both look really good.
Deadpool kind of looks like Deathstroke when you
play
Arts Kai him up.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking the same thing.
I wonder where Liefeld got the idea for that character.
Yeah. I'm surprised he didn't get his ass sued after saying that.
Yeah. All right, next up, I just threw this in there. If you were a comic book collector back in the 90s, we went through a little phase called the Bad Girls.
The Bad
Bad Girls.
I don't know. But I remember collecting this stuff in the mid to late 90s. You had Lady Death, She, Psyblade, Witchblade, Lady Rawhide, go figure. Lots of Evangeline. But now we're getting some figures. So we got Lady Death. Why not? So I threw that in there. No, I don't know if you can take off the garment. No, I don't care. So, but you can tell that it's cold in that glass case. I'll leave it at that.
She is a very well-endowed woman.
She is.
Like, all right. I'm not a big Chaos Comics fan, but the hair is all wrong for Lady Death.
Oh, you need a poofy?
Yeah, because like that's how it was. Like Lady Death had like, you know, like her hair was like almost like a bouffant on top. You know what I mean?
Sindel, yeah, a ton of aerosol.
Yeah, exactly. Whoever said that?
It Sindel looks like you could probably
Mortal Kombat.
It looks like you could probably brush it.
Yeah,
you probably stay up brushing her hair all night.
Yes, I'm going to get it how it needs to be. Come up, come up, come up.
That's a doll.
You're just gonna ask your girl, like, "Hey, babe, can you do this?"
Red Sonja, though.
That's Red Sonja.
Yeah, Red Sonja is nice. I collected those comics too in the early 2000s.
They were good comics, even when
Devil's
Who did it? Dynamite picked it up.
Yeah, Dynamite. Well, yeah,
that's what I was gonna say. Like, this looks straight out of like Gil Simone's Dynamite series.
Yeah, yeah. Really good. Great. Really nice.
Yeah. Shit ton of variant covers. Michael Turner did great covers.
Oh,
and, I'm pretty sure I've seen that axe on a couple Conan covers as well, actually. So that's pretty cool. So, I probably could dig them out.
Three sets of hands. That's nice.
Yeah.
Four. Can what she comes with.
And now we're into figure arts. SH figure arts. We're getting the Bale Batman. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty cool.
Swear to me.
He looks like he's got a cheesy smell, but it might be the light. But yeah, he looks like he's like, yeah. You're gonna buy me.
He looks like he's ready to go to that restaurant.
But the Joker looks kind of weird.
God, it looks like fucking the guy that got to play Lex Luthor done up like the Joker.
Jesse Eisenberg
Joker.
Yeah, that doesn't look good at all. So I'm like, damn.
How did they fuck that up?
Michael Cera.
I don't know, man. I don't know.
Yeah, it's just bad. But I am excited about this. We saw this on the ETR show. I know.
Is this the Figure Arts one or the other company?
Figure Arts. These are all Figure Arts right now.
Okay.
So, Street Fighter Chun Li.
Got the thighs right.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, but.
Hey. Who said they wanted to die with those thighs? Or I would die with those.
With those wrapped around your face?
Around, yeah. Someone saying that. Okay.
Yeah. Unfortunately, you die instantly, so crush your fucking head.
But we're also getting a Ryu, which looks good. A Ryu.
Yeah.
Looks nice.
They can hopefully do a Ken Masters. It'd be great.
Of course they will. And they'll do a Dan and an Akuma and.
Yeah. Does this have a fireball accessory?
I doubt it.
Oh, they won't do like where you swap out the hands like it's throwing a fireball?
Like, it's
such they might, but I don't know. It's the beginning of their line, so they may include some accessory pieces, but Figure Arts is not really kind in that area anymore.
Like, it's such a stupid and small detail, but I really like the eyebrows going over the fucking bandana.
Bandana, yeah.
Yeah.
That's the first thing I noticed. Yeah. Sure, it looks good.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet.
Yeah.
And we got some Dragon Ball figures. We got the premium Cell color edition. Looking forward to that.
Yeah. Yep. The color seems a little off to me.
This one or the other one?
No, this new one. I prefer the original. Mm. Not that I buy it, but just saying.
I like this one. I don't like the fact that they're doing the show accurate ones afterwards. But at least this isn't a San Diego
Comic-Con exclusive. Yeah.
There's Super Saiyan Son Gohan. Just let go. Becomes Super Saiyan 2.
Yes.
You should come with a or maybe he did. Android 16.
Decapitated head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Set him over the edge. Yeah. Or some type of, you know, lightning effect. But Tien, which is cool. A little tri-beam action.
Tri-beam cannon, yeah, that's awesome. I always love Tien. He's my favorite.
Yeah, we got Yamcha.
He better, like I was saying, he better come with a halo.
Damn. They all should come with a halo.
I guess they all die, but...
He should come with his old look with the nappy hair.
The big hair, yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of looks like the dude from Virtua Fighter.
Oh, Kira?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We got Shredder from Figure Arts. We've seen these pictures before, but I just got... No, I didn't pick him up yet. Damn. Thought I did. The Figure Arts Turtles.
So I got to say, he looks kind of cheap.
Cheap.
The head, I don't know, something about the face sculpt, it looks cheap to me, I don't know. Does he? Like when you look at everything else they're putting out?
It's supposed to be like cartoon accurate.
Yeah, it says like this is the best rendition of the classic cartoon. Yeah, but if you like movie figures and want an 18-inch turtle, the NECA movie.
Wow, that's intense. Yeah.
So if you're taking a look at Raphael right now.
Gotta have him.
He's a good claw man.
Look at that pizza. Olives. Sausage.
It has a scar. Oh, that's cool.
Is that like, it looks like it's a rubber molded mask on his face, but cloth at the back, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
There we got Donnie.
Nice.
Meh.
James, do you know the price point on these?
They're going to be probably $110, I believe.
That's not bad.
Like your typical 18-inch. No, unless they change the price point, but yeah.
So this is 18 inches?
Yeah, this is their 1/4 scale, I believe. Yeah, 1/4 scale. So their Deadpool and all that, which I'm surprised hasn't dropped yet. Maybe it has. Texture on the skin. Looks good. All right, moving into Godzilla. This is Shin Godzilla. I believe the movie hit theaters this week or next week. I don't know. But,
this week?
Yeah.
Just in Japan, though, right?
No, there's people in America.
Supposed to be here in the States.
Oh, good. Yeah, I really want to see this.
Looks good. Curious to know why he looks like hell.
This is my favorite version of Godzilla. Like, he's a mutant. He should look completely fucked up. I don't know. I'm on board with this.
But why is his tail split like a microwaved hot dog?
Because he's like...
he's overheating.
Because he's brilliant. I don't know. Because he's a mutant and he's horrible and he's just deformed by radiation.
Where's Charles Xavier when you need him?
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
He shouldn't look like the perfect machine, you know, like he does in the Godzilla, the previous American movies, you know. He's not. He's indestructible and he's fucked up like a cockroach, but like, I don't know.
Cockroach.
He's not natural. Like, he shouldn't look like perfectly tenuous and muscly and awesome, you know. He's born of fallout.
He should be having the meltdown.
Yeah. I think this design's really fucking good.
Next up is the Predator Ultimate Edition.
That's nice.
Predator 2.
Yeah.
You get the city. Time. This is the City Hunter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Predator 2.
Predator 2.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can people hear me, or am I just talking out of my ass?
Well, you only said Predator 2. I mean.
Okay. Do you want me to be more specific?
Well.
I'm just curious.
No, well, there's different Predators in Predator 2. Besides just
the well, okay, let's just go. The one that we all know. The one that has the most screen time.
Kills the king in the alley, dude.
I didn't know we needed to be very specific.
These guys look really cool, though. They did a good job on them.
Yeah, those like elbow pins are solid.
What I like is the net feature.
Oh, shit. Yeah,
that's,
yeah.
It's cool.
That's cool. Yeah, that's sweet.
Wow.
I like the little dial. That's impressive.
And next up, Power Rangers. I know it's Shia time, but this is a New York Comic Con exclusive, much like they did with San Diego Comic Con, but this is the movie Red Ranger. You do get the power coin. I think that's the only thing that's
this is different. Bandai still has Power Rangers.
Yeah. I think they're doing a good job with the new Legacy line.
Yeah.
I don't like the scale it, but I do like the figures getting closer to that figure arts, but not costing as much as a figure art.
Yeah.
I almost bought the Green Ranger today.
Next up, we have the Black Titanus. So if you have the Dragon Zord and the Megazord, now you can complete the full team. Mm. It's got all the same features as the original release, metal chain, all that type of stuff. It's going to probably have the same price point too, around $200. Diecast, all that. Oh, and you also get the Red Ranger's Power Sword, which is, wow.
That's like properly scaled prop replica?
Yep. That's I mean, we cool. got Samba or whatever, the White Rangers, and now mm-hmm. we're actually getting this one.
And the Power Watch is in there and stuff, too.
Yeah, I'll admit I got the Green Ranger's communicator.
Yeah, I saw that at Toys R Us. It's pretty cool.
It is pretty cool.
And we're also getting Solid Shogokin GX-72 Daijujin, which is the Megazord.
That's a mouthful.
Yeah, Kairu's Daijujin. Ranger. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's super
cool. Diecast, all that.
I always liked how he had the mammoth head as a shield.
Yeah.
Super cool.
Looking forward to the Ninja Megazord in the Legacy line.
Would you buy this though, Charles? Would you pick this up?
Yeah.
I mean, this is probably equivalent to what the Masterpiece, even though some people would say the Legacy, but Solid Shogokin, you can't go wrong.
No.
Looks good. I mean, like the Voltron that's coming out.
What's he going to be priced at?
I think he's like 200.
Give or take. Okay.
Yeah. A little bit too.
Yeah.
You can do all the different, all the.
That's cool. Combinations. Yeah.
Yeah. That's cool. Yeah.
Very iconic.
Tank. Yeah, the tank mode.
And lots of nice detail in there. They're cool.
Oh, a little other features. I'm going to try and quickly go through this because I still need to get to the last one fast. Yeah.
Oh shit! On the chain launcher.
Yeah.
That's cool.
That's an awesome.
Still
feature.
Nothing really, really too weak with the pterodactyl.
Really weak.
Yeah.
Even that.
Oh.
It's pretty sad. Would've been cool if they kept little Power Rangers. All right, so you guys like turtles, you guys like wrestling. Well, now you can have a Walmart exclusive Superstar Ninja Turtle.
The toy we've been waiting for.
Oh, yeah. Donatello is the Undertaker.
Okay.
Or how they
animated it. Because
that's the one that Donatello would become.
The undead.
Liam is John Cena, huh?
And Leonardo is John Cena.
Cue the music.
That makes sense.
And here, Michelangelo is Macho Man Randy Savage.
Oh, God.
Oh, man.
And then Raphael and Sting.
Raphael and Sting. Okay. That's cool. Raphael and Sting. How about that?
That's appropriate.
Yeah. Flying off the shelves for all those mashup lovers.
Walmart exclusive. Get yours now.
Because nobody else wanted it.
Yeah. $20. All right. Moving into Voltron. We got inundated with a ton of Voltron pre-order stuff. We have the normal 6-inch figures, but we also get a combiner.
Yep.
That will, is it 16 inches tall when it's combined or something like that?
Mm-hmm. You know, there. Oh, that was, I remember that guy. He's pretty.
And it's nice we're getting some villains.
Yeah.
Although he's kind of like, he kind of looks like a Happy Meal toy.
But with articulation, you got some articulation.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, well, it's better than nothing.
For sure. The Lion Bots have, you know, some ratcheting joints. It looks like they don't look too bad.
Now, this is the larger scale version, and they're priced pretty good. You get the little pilot.
Mm.
That's nice.
Accessory. Oh, yeah, it's like a pilot pod, eh?
Yeah. So we got the blue, we looked at the black. Green.
Yep.
Red.
That sword's dope.
They're not bad.
No, they're not bad. It's the combined form of Voltron that I'm not crazy about. I like the individual lions.
Yeah, it actually looks a lot less good here.
Well, this isn't the other version of that. This is just your standard non.
Oh, that's the 6-inch again.
This is actually the 18-inch. This is the bigger one.
Oh, shit.
But there's three different sizes.
Okay, so this isn't the combiner one.
This is a 14-incher.
Okay. Yeah.
So. Is that one the combined one?
No, this is not the combined one.
No, yeah. He doesn't have the limbs on the individual bots. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So. Yeah. I would give it a try. I mean, the Black Ranger's only $40. The other ones aren't going to be that much money. Happen to see him. 16 inches. We'll see. See how good it. All right. Now we're doing the Blast of the Past. Finally made it to that point in time. Going to be taking a look at Ghostbusters. This is the Filmation Ghostbusters. This is the original Ghostbusters. I know some people will dispute that. But the Ghostbusters live action came out in 1975.
Yeah,
a lot earlier than the 1984 release of the Harold Ramis, and then it both spawned cartoons that came out in 1986. This has been now redubbed as Ghostbusters Filmation, whereas the other one was called when it came out The Real Ghostbusters and all that type of stuff.
Right.
This is the original logo of the 1975 TV show, which aired in September 6, 1975 to December 13th of the same year. Only 15 episodes, so it didn't really pan out. There's your cast.
Tracy the Gorilla.
Tracy the Gorilla, Larry Storch, Bob Burns as him, Boris Tucker from F Troop. And there's their vehicle. Just want to do a little bit of history because the cartoon actually is a spin-off
of
the
live-action show, which the cartoon was done by Filmation.
So Jake Kong was the son of one of those characters, right?
Yes, Jake Kong Jr. They didn't really change their names. Yeah. They just went from senior to junior.
Yeah.
Okay.
Lou Schreimer, a producer, he's done, you know, obviously Masters of the Universe, Brave Star, all that type of stuff. The Filmation cartoon came out in September 8th, 1986 to December 5th. Of the same year, 65 episodes.
Mm. But that was one season, right?
Yeah.
Fully syndicated.
Yeah. And then we did get a comic book series. There was supposed to be 6 in total, but they only released 4. But supposedly there is a German collection or a collection that was released in Germany of all 6. Something like that. I don't know.
Back in the day, $125. Whew.
Yeah. That's pricey.
So, what was the never mind. You'll get to it later. Never mind.
We will.
Yeah.
You did get a DVD release. These are a little bit more on the pricey side if you try and go after them. I think Milton Creek is the licensor of this now. But volumes one, volume two. I believe there's some other, and there's always bootlegs, and there's always UK releases and all that type of stuff. There's the team. You got Tracy's back. You got Jake Kong Jr. in the middle. You got Eddie Spencer Jr. And this is before, they get a call. They say, let's go Ghostbusters. And they slap hands. So much fun. They're the voice actors.
Let's go. Alan Oppenheim.
Yep.
Peter Cullen.
Susan Blue.
Yep.
And everyone else is from Masters of the Universe, He-Man. So
pretty much.
Alan Oppenheimer, Linda Gray,
Yeah.
So, all right, like I stated. What?
I'm sorry. I was just going to say, is that why? Never mind. I'm sorry. I don't want to give it away. Go ahead. Sorry.
Okay. As I was saying before, that the characters carried over from the live action, you did see them in the show. And it was pretty good likeness, I guess, except for him. They didn't really capture that guy too much. But a lot of things did carry over, like the ghost buggy. So this is, you saw the ghost buggy, the original in the cartoon. Their little dematerializer weapon carried over into the cartoon from the live action. And then you also have their weapons here, the ghost gummer, the ecto strobe, the specter snare, and bubble blaster. They've had other weapons, but I'm not going to feature every single gadget they have.
Just the good ones.
Yeah, essentially. And then they also had various other kind of characters. The Ansabone. They had great names too. The Skelevator, where they actually transformed into their uniforms. The Skeleton Television. And the shot clock.
The Skeletelevision, not the Skelevision?
The Skelevision. Okay. Yeah, sorry, Skelevision.
Okay, I was going to say.
Yeah,
sorry. Drop the ball there.
And they're all voiced by Lou Schreimer and Erica Schreimer. And then we're moving into the toys here. Shaper was the ones who had the license of the Ghostbusters, but then they were bought out by Tyco in 1986. Not sure which ones are more valuable. I believe the ones that are Tyco. I really don't see a lot of those. Man, look at that hair. All right, characters. We have Jake Kong Jr., voiced by Pat Fraley. You can see him there from the anime, from the cartoon, and there he is in his toy, who looks a lot like Pete Sinclair. Right there. Just saying.
Yeah.
And then you have Eddie Spencer Jr., who has the same kind of look of Prince Adam. Voiced by Peter Cullen, who his character is the putz of the group. You got Tracy the Gorilla, voiced by Lou Schreimer. Not a lot going on with these toys. They don't really have any articulation. And there's a lot of chipping that can happen.
But that backpack, though.
Yeah. And then we have Jessica Ray, voiced by Susan Blue. And, man, she's got a nice V cut going on there.
Yeah, really.
V. Like, what's up with that? And the hair.
No cleavage.
Again, this is a toy line for boys, so again we got a female character, which is interesting. Got actually quite a few.
Doll hair.
Yeah, no. Straight up doll hair. Petra, another one. Another female character. Voiced by Linda Gray. Voiced by Susan Blue, sorry.
Toy didn't get the headphones. Oh no, it did. It did get the headphones.
So. Did figure did come with a comic book too. And then we have Belfry,
which is looks like a complete ripoff of who's that? Shit, he's a pig bat, but whatever. Anyways,
yeah, it's Piglet. other characters that we saw on the show, the little dorky nephew of Jessica, Corky, Madam Y.
Madam Y's looking pretty haggard.
Yeah, it is looking needed the meal. For what it's worth, I mean, 65 episodes, Ghostbusters, this was entertaining, but I don't think it really holds the test of time. Not a lot of 80s cartoons do.
Yeah,
but
that's true.
For some reason, these characters that we're looking at right now never got a toy. It's pretty good. We got Merlin. We got Fuddy. That was a great name. Fuddy. Lou Schimer. Alan Oppenheimer. Foxfire. Some other characters. And we actually got a playset, which is the Ghost Command.
You got a dollhouse.
Pretty much. It's a fold-out dollhouse, much like Castle Grayskull and
Snowmelt.
So, there you go. Ghost Buggy.
Ghost Buggy. Oh, transformed.
Cool. It's a triple changer.
That's awesome.
Triple changer technology.
Boat, car, plane.
Hasbro should take notes.
Yeah, they should. Yeah. They're designing their stuff off of the Ghostbusters. Well, we got the Time Hopper.
This thing's pretty cool, actually.
This was future as a little vehicle. Oh, the motto for all their toys was "So much fun, it's spooky."
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Yeah. Next up, Primeval.
That's his name. Thank you. Couldn't remember his name.
This is This is characters voiced by Alan Oppenheimer.
Yeah. That's why he sounded like Skeletor.
Yep.
Skeletor.
He could hardly say why. Ghostbusters, so we always called him Ghost Boobs and Ghost this and Ghost everything. But yeah.
As a kid, I wondered why he sounded like Skeletor.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So what is he? Is he like a robot ghost?
He's a dark robotic wizard.
Yeah, and he's goofy as hell.
He is.
Scraped in the bottom of the barrel for that one.
Prime. Yeah, they were. Yeah, they were.
Yeah,
I mean, you got Skimmer Stiff.
There's his henchman, obviously.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Like Scared yes Stiff, man. AKA the skeleton.
Scared Stiff. AKA Fear Boner.
Next one up is Fangster. Oh no, not Fangster. Sorry. It's Rat-a-Rat.
Right.
Which is a ghost slug rat. Is he a ghost rat or is he a slug rat?
He's some type of character that you kind of almost see in the real Ghostbusters.
He kind of looks like a spleen.
Now we have Fangster. Rat-a-Rat was voiced by Peter Cullen.
Yeah, the werewolf guy.
Looks trustworthy.
Telephone. Time to get up. Time to take your meds.
Sorry.
No, that's all good.
Go ahead.
Party for one. Oh, next God. Up is Haunter.
Oh, Thunder Thighs.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I had to rewatch a lot of this stuff, and man, this does not hold up to take some pictures.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, it was
birthing hips.
This guy's a douche.
Oh,
I just
yeah.
Yeah, Mysteria.
Oh, yeah, I remember her. I do remember her.
Not bad.
That's funny, James. I didn't know they made a toy for her. That's one I don't remember seeing. Huh.
Well, now you got a reason to go on eBay.
Yeah, I know. I got to go to Google look now, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's a terrible rabbit hole to go down.
Anyway. Next up is Fib Face, but he's also called Double Face.
Because he's got two faces.
Yeah.
Naming.
Hey,
he also has a dress. If you didn't catch that, he's wearing a little skirt. Or is it a tunic? No, it's a skirt. That's a dress.
It's something that we'll see in POP, Princess of Power. next up, Ghostbuster, the villain's Bone Troller.
Bone Troller.
There is. His freaking
Primeval's awesome control center, which happens to be an organ, I guess.
I love the 80s. They were great.
Yeah. It's too bad it didn't have any, you know, actual features.
If, you know, it featured five ghostly visions. I think you're mistaken there.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm just talking music-wise, but yeah. You got the Scare Scooter.
Got a sunroof. That's nice.
Got a sunroof.
And other characters that we saw on the show but never got it.
Oh, so, see, this girl on the bottom is pretty scary looking.
Medusa?
Yeah.
No, you're going to like this one. This dude right here, Captain Long John Scarecrow.
Yeah.
Long John Scarecrow. Hmm.
So he's a great name.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. Sir Trancelot.
Sir Trancelot. Yeah.
Okay. How about Camp Freeze or Flozart?
Flozart. He plays the bone.
He plays the bone.
The bone.
Who's the chick with the blue hair?
The what? Who?
The chick with the blue hair.
Where? Here?
Yeah. Apparition.
Yeah.
Apparition.
And her little minions who look like, I don't know, little green giants.
And didn't she talk like she was Mae West or something like that?
Yeah. Yeah, she did. Unfortunately, I couldn't mute it. You got Airhead, you got Dr. Creep, you got Wormwood, you got the two Scaries.
Wormwood, that's actually a pretty literal, literary based name, I guess you'd say.
And then some other characters that,
some guy eating a bucket of semen, apparently.
And then you got Primeval's kind of nemesis, which was Big Evil.
Big Evil.
And then he got his siblings, Primeval's siblings.
Primeval's mom and his sister.
His wife and illegitimate child.
Oh, God. And then
that's it for the Ghostbusters. I know it wasn't that spectacular. It wasn't Thundercats or anything, but I thought, what the hell? It's Halloween. Why not?
Yeah. All right. So,
take a look at that.
I learned something.
All right. Confession
not
time.
To watch that.
Who watched that show when they were kids?
Never even knew it existed.
Yeah, same
here.
I watched it. I was the dumbass that watched it.
You weren't the
Ghostbusters. I will say this: the Groovy Ghoulies did make a cameo appearance on the show. No. Drac and his wife.
Oh, Drac! Oh,
shit. Yeah, the Groovy Ghoulies. So,
yeah.
If you remember that, but other than that.
Weren't they from an old Hanna-Barbera cartoon?
Yeah.
Huh. So, there we have it.
That was cool.
All right, so we got through the damn show. Yay! 2.5 hours.
Covered a lot of stuff there, man.
Yeah.
It would have been long if I had a show last week because of the New York Comic Con stuff. Thank God I didn't. And Dust took the realm on that, which I appreciate. And he does a great job.
Yeah, it was a pretty good show on last Saturday. We did a good job, covered a lot of cool stuff.
There we go. All right, so anything you guys want to talk about, or we just cut it short?
Short. All heavy quotes there.
Okay, so thanks everyone for checking out the show, whether it's live, if you're in the chat, or being on the panel and seeing a video form, all that type of stuff. Next weekend is TFCon, so for everyone that's going to TFCon, be safe, have fun. Looking forward to all the pictures and the stories and all that type of stuff. But we'll have a show. I'll have a show. Probably just me and Charles. Because we're the only ones not going. But we'll try and hold it down. And make sure you check out the ETR this Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Realm of Collectors YouTube channel, and go order your Rock Pack shirt. Whether you're going to TFCon or not, there's no reason not to get one.
Don't be that guy.
So don't be that one person at TFCon that doesn't have the shirt and everyone's staring and pointing. So there you go. All right, let's do some outros. Charles, where can people find you?
All right. Find me on Twitter and Instagram at Optimus4Prez.
Cool. And Tron Viper.
You can find me on IG at Tron Viper and on the Realm of Collectors Facebook group, David McLeod. So,
thanks for being on the show, man.
Yeah, thanks for having it, man.
No problem. And Mr. Northern Warrior Matt Ironclaw Ellis.
Hey, you can find me on Facebook at Matt Ellis and on IG as Iron_Claw.
Awesome. Up next, Masterpiece Shitpiece.
What's up? You can find me at Nick Brammer on Facebook and at Brammer_Nick on Twitter.
And next up is Big Russ.
What's up, guys? You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Yeah, I like to post shit on the ROC page and in Facebook. So,
cool. And Trends 5.
Find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Trends 5.
Awesome. And you can find me on Instagram and YouTube, VictorySaber77. And you can find me on the ETR show this Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We'll be back next week. We will have a show. I'm sure we'll have some people pop in from TFCon. Whether they're sober or not, we'll never know. but it's all good. So yeah, thanks for watching. Make sure you check out the Cool Table Network. Subscribe, like, do all that stuff. 5-star. You can find this show on iTunes also. Awesome. All right, that is it.